Chapter 1151, A Struggle Between the Strong. 1. Every time the saint's fruit appears, a saint king will be able to reach saint emperor. Now that the saint's fruit has appeared, it looks like another saint emperor will appear on the Tianyuan continent. That's a blessing for the continent, Wu Chenzi murmured to herself before turning to Qing Ying Hu. She said, have some time to yourself for the next few days. I really do hope you can sever all mortal affairs and break free from the chains. With that, the pavilion master walked outside. A struggle filled Qing Ying Hu's eyes, but it would be replaced by confusion from time to time. He seemed to have no idea what he should do, becoming lost. He could not find the path he needed to walk. Suddenly, Qing Ying Hu looked toward Wu Chenzi, who was just about to leave through the door. He said, pavilion master, I want to visit home. Qing Ying Hu, are you still worrying about the matters at your home? The pavilion master stopped and said without turning back. It's already been many years since I've last returned. I have no idea what the situation there is like right now, as well as my younger brother and sister's situation. A rare sliver of reminiscence filled Qing Ying Hu's eyes. Your worries are unnecessary. The Qing Yang clan is currently as brilliant as the noon sun, and your younger brother has already become an expert that can shake the continent, the pavilion master gently sighed. But I still want to go back. I want to see my mother, said Qing Ying Hu. After a momentary pause, the pavilion master said, go back. Return back to the mortal world and comprehend it. It might help you. Qing Ying Hu immediately set off from the Pure Heart Pavilion. The pavilion master did not directly send Qing Ying Hu to the Qing Yang clan through a space gate. She instead got him to travel by himself. She made him travel the huge distance to return back to the Jisun Kingdom by himself. Just as Qing Ying Hu left, an ordinary-looking middle-aged man arrived before the pavilion master. He clasped his hands. Pavilion master, the Jisun Kingdom is very far away from here. Qing Ying Hu will definitely come across some difficulties along the way. Wu Xin, protect him in secret. Only interfere when his life is threatened, commanded the pavilion master. Yes, pavilion master. Wu Xin suddenly disappeared with a sway of his body. He shot off in the direction that Qing Ying Hu had set off in with extremely great speed. The pavilion master returned to an extremely simple discussion hall. It had been filled with people long ago. They were all important figures of the pavilion. Pavilion master, the saint's fruit that only appears once every 40,000 years has ripened. How should we respond? Do we take part in the fight for it? A gray-haired old man stood up and asked the pavilion master. Wu Chenzi sat on an extremely old cushion. She calmly said, we practice the Pure Heart Sutra of the Pure Heart Pavilion. We have to purify our heart from passions and desires so that we do not become entranced by foreign objects. We have never participated in the fight for the saint's fruit every single time it has appeared. At most, a few seniors went with some experts to study the mysteries of the death nest, so we will not be participating either this time. At the same time, a huge blade floated 3 meters above the ground in the forbidden grounds of the Tyrant's Blade School. It shined with a layer of brilliant light. A burly, middle-aged man in robes sat on the hilt of the blade. Strands of extremely pure energy leaked out of the blade, which were then absorbed by the middle-aged man like a whale taking in water. He was the founding ancestor of the Tyrant's Blade School, Gai Haiyadao. He was currently cultivating by absorbing the energy within the Emperor armament. Over 100 Emperor armaments had fused with the blade already. The energy gathered in there had reached an extremely terrifying level where even Saint Kings at great perfection found it difficult to control. They would suffer extremely severe backlashes as well. However, as the original owner of the Emperor armament, Gai Haiyadao could use the weapon like a third arm. Even though he was not at great perfection, he would not suffer any backlashes. Suddenly, Gai Haiyadao's eyes snapped open. 2 streaks of terrifying light shot from his eyes, piercing through empty space, shattering it. The light reduced it into chaos, and soon after, images of the death nest appeared clearly. The space distorted constantly, making it very difficult to make out the feature there. However, a bright, 9-colored light appeared. What is this? Gai Haiyadao's face changed. He struggled to keep his composure, and only after quite a while did he sigh in amazement. What a powerful formation and what heaven-defying methods. Who was the one responsible for this? Several figures flew over with lightning speed from the distance. Gai Haiyada returned to how he was before, and the space in front of him had recovered as well. The people were the great elders of the Tyrant's Blade School. They knelt down politely outside the forbidden grounds and one of them courteously reported, "Ancestor, the saint's fruit that appears once every 40,000 years has ripened. May we have permission to proceed to the death cavern and retrieve the saint's fruit so the ancestor can return to Saint Emperor?" "The saint's fruit? What's that?" Gai Haiyada became rather interested. He did not originate from the same age as Mo Tanyun, and he had only just returned to the Protector Clan. He was obviously uncertain about what had happened in the past with Mo Tanyun. The Great Elders explained all the information regarding the Saint's Fruit in detail. However, when Gai Haiyada heard that the fruit could allow people to reach Saint Emperor, he did not show any hint of joy at all. He remained extremely calm and said, "I have no need for the Saint's Fruit, but it might be rather useful for you. You can go." The Great Elders beamed with joy. With what was said, they could tell that their ancestor did not need the Saint's Fruit to reach Saint Emperor, which obviously made them extremely excited and joyous. The Great Elders all left the Tyrant's Blade School. With their departure, Gai Haiyada left the Forbidden Grounds as well. He entered the library there, diligently reading through the records regarding Mo Tanyun and the Death Nest. At the same time, experts left the Qing Yang Clan, the Muan Clan, the Yangjai Sect, the Shengxiao Sect, the Potent Sect, the Yuan Sect, the Heaven's Incense School and the Heartless School. They directly ripped open space gates to travel to the Death Nest. Other than them, the supreme experts of Mercenary City were mobilized as well. There was not just Tian Jian who was at the great perfection of Saint King. There were also the elderly people who had remained in seclusion and had only appeared during the invasion of the Hundred Races. They were approaching the end of their lives and wanted to use their final moments to obtain the Saint's Fruit and breakthrough to Saint Emperor. A few ancient clans with lengthy legacies and a deep heritage possessed records of the Saint's Fruit as well. All the Saint Kings in their clans were mobilized as well. At that moment, the Death Nest became the center of attention for all the Saint Kings on the Tianyuan continent. This was because the powerful rippling of the mysteries of the world could undoubtedly allow people to reach Saint Emperor. Even a few Saint Kings who had no idea of the fruit's existence ripped open space gates and hurried over, wanting to understand just what was going on. Chapter 1152, A Struggle Between the Strong. 2. The only remaining Saint King of the Tsar family stood in a large courtyard as he stared into the distance within the City of God. Tsar Vamo's face was filled with both doubt and surprise. "Has someone on the Tianyuan continent broken through to Saint Emperor?" "No, that doesn't seem right. These mysteries of the world seem to be due to the birth of a Saint Emperor, but they are completely different from the records," Tsar Vamos softly muttered. He seemed to think of something and his face changed abruptly. He cried out, "I remember now. It's the saint's fruit. This is the saint's fruit that is recorded to only appear once every 40,000 years. It's said that the fruit can allow a saint king to reach Saint Emperor." Tsar Vamos' breathing suddenly became ragged. At this current date, it was very difficult to reach Saint Emperor. Many people were stuck at great perfection for their whole lives, unable to advance, which was why becoming a Saint Emperor was extremely tempting to all Saint Kings. It was enough for all the supreme experts who stood at the apex of the continent to fight with one another until they were all bloodied and battered. But, the next moment, Tsar Vamo's face darkened. He became filled with sorrow and helplessness. He deeply sighed, "It's a pity that Kaiyan. Otherwise, my Tsar family might have been able to try get the Saint's Fruit." Sigh. "I sure do regret the past. I was wrong back then." At the same time, the Saint King ancestors of the Kara clan and Kazda clan all came out of seclusion in the other two capital cities of the Holy Empire. They looked in the direction of the Death Nest with glowing eyes and left hurriedly after handing over some matters. Simultaneously, Saint Kings departed from the Karl Empire and Felicity Empire as well. all heading toward the Death Nest. The Death Nest was located in an extremely desolate region where people would rarely appear, yet it had become lively today, something that rarely occurred. As space gates ripped open, Saint Kings hurried over from all directions. At that moment, over two-thirds of all the Saint Kings on the Tianyuan continent had gathered outside the Death Nest. Only an extremely low number of people did not participate. Right now, the entire Death Nest was enveloped by a magnificent, nine-colored light. It dyed the surroundings with many colors as thunder boomed in the sky. The tribulation lighting fell bolt after bolt. The commotion was huge. The vast pressure caused many Saint Kings to change their expressions. What's happening? Why has this happened in the Death Nest? Has someone been cultivating in the Death Nest and reached Saint Emperor? Many Saint Kings discussed the matter with one another. All of them were curious. Only a few clans that possessed an ancient heritage and knew about the Saint's fruit remained silent. They did not want to leak the secret of the fruit. Half a day later, the tribulation lightning in the sky dispersed. The Saint's fruit had successfully made it through the tribulation with the help of the formation in the Death Nest, and it had absorbed a large quantity of pure energy from the lightning. It completed its final evolution and became the real thing. The Saint's fruit had become simple now. Its multicolored light had completely disappeared, and all of its energy and vast amounts of essence had completely withdrawn. None of it leaked out, and it had returned to its simple form. Even the nine leaves around it were the same. At the same time, some of the Saint Kings outside the Death Nest began to move. The first people were the ten protector clans and a few ancient clans. They had charged into the Death Nest at almost the same time. They knew the secret in the depths of the Death Nest. Their ancestors had already probed into the matter regarding the Saint's fruit many times, around a dozen. Their records described it very clearly. So everyone knew that right now was the perfect time to collect the fruit. Immediately, over 100 Saint Kings entered the Death Nest. With the people of the 10 protector clans leading them, they flew to the depths with an unstoppable force. They did not bother with the vengeful spirits that they came across along the way. Any powerful vengeful spirit that blocked their way would be struck with several, or even a dozen combined attacks from Saint Kings. They would collapse into mist in a single instance. There must be some heaven-defying treasure in the Death Nest. Let's all go in and take a look. That's right. Otherwise, how could it attract the people of the 10 protector clans? The Death Nest may be terrifying, but if so many Saint Kings like us work together, we can easily trample through this place. Many people revealed their thoughts outside the Death Nest. They had all realized something from the movements of the Protector and Ancient Clans, so they all charged in as well. The Death Nest was terrifying with its extremely powerful Saint Emperor vengeful spirits, but basically two-thirds of the Tianyuan continent's supreme power had gathered here. Even if they came across Saint Emperor vengeful spirits, they could disperse them easily, which was why every single person was filled with confidence. The Saint Kings had entered the Death Nest in two waves. The people of the first wave moved very quickly. They could almost be described as swift as the wind, using only 2 hours to reach the second zone of the Death Nest. They continued on without slowing down at all, proceeding to the third zone. All the wonders of the Saint's fruit had already disappeared. It no longer radiated with any fragrances, but the Saint Emperor vengeful spirits did not disperse. They remained there like before, meditating. The vengeful spirits had benefited a ton after absorbing the fragrance of the Saint's fruit. Their bodies were now even more consolidated. In the golden miniature world, Ji and Chen, Taita, Ruijin, Hongliang, and Haiyu sat on the ground as they stared unblinkingly through the mirror. They were all waiting, waiting for the moment the vengeful spirits would leave. At this moment, the group of Saint Kings that had entered the second zone were obstructed by over 10 vengeful spirits. Although they had wiped out the vengeful spirits in the blink of an eye, the powerful ripples of energy reached the third zone. A gleam of light flashed through Ruijin's eyes in the miniature world. He seemed to sense something and immediately cut open his finger. With a drop of his blood, he cast a secret technique to create another mirror in the air. The blurriness of the mirror cleared up very quickly. A group of human experts who glowed with various colors appeared in the mirror, quickly flying toward the third zone. SHT, it's the people of the Protector Clans. They've come to the Death Nest as well, Jian Chen had seen the people of the Protector Clans before, so he recognized them with a single glance. His face immediately became ugly. Chapter 1153, A Struggle Between the Strong, 3. The Protector Clans have arrived sooner than I expected. The ripening of the Saint's Fruit caused too large of a disturbance. I just never thought they'd actually come so quickly, said Ruijin. What do we do now? Do we get the people of the Protector Clans to fight with those vengeful spirits and get them to attract their attention? And once they obtain the Saint's Fruit, we steal it over in a crucial moment? Hong Lian inquired. All of them contemplated the situation. Stealing the Saint's Fruit from a group of vengeful spirits or a great party of Saint Kings would both be difficult. In terms of battle prowess, the Saint Kings that had charged in from outside were nowhere near as strong as the Saint Emperor vengeful spirits. However, they could work together, and there were many of them who knew Saint-tier battle skills and various ancient secret techniques. They were not easy to deal with either. Ruijin glanced at Jian Chen. He said, let's not steal the Saint's Fruit from the hands of the 10 Protector Clans. That might lead to a lot of people panicking and doing some impulsive things. After all, the Saint's Fruit is no ordinary item. It's the only shortcut to Saint Emperor. So is there anybody willing to let it be stolen from them? Jian Chen nodded slightly with that. Ruijin was looking out for Jian Chen with what he suggested. Jian Chen was not just a single person. He needed to consider the people around him. The Qingyang clan in Lore City, the Jisung Kingdom, and the Flame Mercenaries could not endure abuse from the Protector Clans and the Ancient Clans. Although these large organizations were usually disinclined to do things like that, the Saint's Fruit that could let people reach Saint Emperor was involved this time. The great temptation could easily drive people mad. Time was tight right now. They began to move as soon as they came up with a plan. A gate opened in the Golden World and Jian Chen, Ruijin, Ai Yu, and Hong Lian all flew out. They flew over the heads of many vengeful spirits, quickly charging toward the Saint's Fruit. Tai Ta did not come out. In order to protect his identity, he was persuaded into the artifact space by Jian Chen within the miniature world. Their appearance immediately garnered the attention of all the vengeful spirits present. At that moment, all of them stopped meditating and stood up in unison. Without saying anything, they all charged at the four of them. Jian Chen, Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Hai Yu had made preparations long ago. Chaotic force filled every corner of Jian Chen's body, pushing the defenses of his chaotic body to the limit. As for the three others, they had drawn their origin energy treasures, ready to attack and defend. A devastating streak of light flickered by. Ruijin's sword and Hai Yu's machete were swung out simultaneously, sending out a strand of powerful sword chi and blade chi toward the many vengeful spirits up ahead. A layer of white flames had coated Hong Lian's scorching godfire hairpin as she coordinated with Ruijin and Hai Yu to wipe out the enemies at the front. As the three origin energy treasures struck out at the same time, the power was unimaginable. It could destroy space and annihilate everything. It collapsed the vengeful spirits that rushed forward at the front without any difficulty at all, reducing them into black mist. Under the power of the origin energy, the vengeful spirits quickly weakened. However, it was not enough to deal with them completely. Their bodies were quickly reconstructed, but the attacks had paved a path. They immediately used it to quickly approach the fruit. However, there were just far too many vengeful spirits that charged over from all directions. Over 500 vengeful spirits formed a wall to encircle them. They all struck out the same time as various attacks rained down on the small group, almost drowning them like a flood. Swinging her hand, 9 fire red phoenix feathers flew out of Hong Lian's hand. The feathers expanded in the wind, rapidly growing larger before becoming 9 flying phoenixes over 100 meters long. Flames burned around them, causing the temperature to quickly skyrocket. The 9 phoenixes did not attack, and instead, they quickly flew about in a circle. They moved faster and faster before transforming into a fire-red barrier that surrounded the four of them. The barrier blocked the attacks from all the vengeful spirits. There were a few lacking materials for the Phoenix's guard, so the full strength of the formation cannot be used. It can't last for very long, So let's move a little faster. We need to obtain the fruit as soon as possible, Hong Lian gruffly informed them. She then took control of the formation, quickly moving forward with it. Muffled sounds constantly rang out. They originated from all the attacks that rained down on the formation, causing the light screen created by the phoenixes to constantly tremble. The vengeful spirits blocked their way like a black mass, but Hong Lian slowly advanced by controlling the formation, traveling less than 1,000 meters in 5 whole minutes. Every single step for them could be described as arduous. Finally, the formation shattered with a loud sound. The vengeful spirits in the surroundings immediately appeared before Jian Chen and the others, charging toward them in a blanketing fashion. Ruijin moved just in time. He threw out 18 dragon scales. Each scale had undergone a special refinement, so they were covered with inscriptions. The 18 scales levitated in the air, shining with a streak of light which intertwined with one another to protect their small group. Coming out this time, Ruijin and Hong Lian had both made sufficient preparations. They had created many defensive formations and many killing formations, so even though they faced an extremely terrifying amount of vengeful spirits, they felt no fear. Tiny cracks appeared on the 18 scales after lasting for 5 minutes. They clearly could not last much longer anymore, yet the four of them had only advanced by 1,000 meters. We've only prepared a limited number of formations. We can't use them all, so we need to advance quicker. Jian Chen, you enter the artifact space first. We'll kill our way over together, Ruijin spoke gruffly. Without any deliberation, Jian Chen pulled out the Saint Artifact and disappeared into it. The Saint Artifact was then placed in Ruijin's bosom. The moment the 18 scales shattered, the three of them erupted with their peak strength. They stabbed through the obstructing spirits like a blade, charging forward with an unstoppable force. Along the way, the three of them resisted the many powerful attacks from the vengeful spirits. They would have become heavily injured long ago if it were not for the origin energy treasures on them. At the same time, all the Saint Kings led by the Protector Clans had entered the third zone. Saint force of various attributes flickered around them, which made them seem like tiny lanterns from afar. They used their full strength to resist the vile energies present. As soon as they entered the third zone, their faces immediately changed. All their attention gathered in a single direction. The disturbance created by Ruijin, Hong Lian, Hai Yu, and the vengeful spirits was just far too great. Even with such a great distance between them, they could still sense the violent ripples of energy. Sht, someone's gotten here before us. They've already started fighting with the vengeful spirits, a red-robed old man growled. He was a great elder from the Heavens Incense School. The saint's fruit has only just ripened, and we arrived here in the shortest amount of time possible. How could they have made it here before us? A ruddy but sagely old man from the Shenxiao sect wondered out loud. He frowned heavily. The people over there are extremely powerful, and they're no weaker than a few of us. They can actually fight so ferociously against the encirclement of vengeful spirits. This isn't something people at great perfection can do, Yi Yangtzai of the Yuan sect said. The light in his eyes flickered. Perhaps it's a saint emperor? Surely it isn't the Path Lord of Carnal Desires, right? A saint king from another protector clan suggested. Chapter 1154, A Struggle Between the Strong. 4. The Saint Kings from the Protector and Ancient Clans immediately charged in the direction the battle had erupted. Almost all the vengeful spirits in the third zone of the Death Nest had gathered around the Saint's Fruit, so there were very few vengeful spirits elsewhere. This allowed the party of Saint Kings to travel without problems. There was not a single vengeful spirit that blocked their way until they reached the edge of the battle. However, all of them became dumbfounded when they arrived. They all stared in front in astoundment as they experienced a great shock. In front of them, over 500 Saint Emperor vengeful spirits formed a black mass. They surged toward a location in a blanketing fashion, and all of them used various powerful attacks. The attacks drowned the area, causing the ground to rumble. Dazzling golden sword chi would shoot out from the encirclement of countless vengeful spirits from time to time. There would also be white flames between the spirits, radiating with a terrifying temperature. However, It was impossible to see the people trapped in the encirclement. Only a Saint Emperor can block the attacks from so many Saint Emperor vengeful spirits. But we only have a single human Saint Emperor, and it's clearly not him. So who are they? Are they the Saint Emperors from the Beast God continent? No, they're not Saint Emperors from the Beast God continent. Their presences are completely off. Does that mean that there's more than a single Saint Emperor on our continent? The people from the Protector clans and the Ancient clans were all greatly shocked. In the current age, there were extremely few Saint Emperors. Even with the entire world in perspective, there was a countable amount of them. Yet two Saint Emperors had just suddenly appeared here. This was an extremely astounding piece of news. Suddenly, an extremely terrifying ripple of energy erupted. All that could be seen was a huge, glimmering sword chi, a dazzling blade of light, and a burning, 3-meter-long hairpin break from the encirclement together. Wherever they passed, the vengeful spirits would collapse into dark mist. They had dispersed over 20 vengeful spirits instantly. A gap appeared in the encirclement of the vengeful spirits, and Ruijin, Honglian, and Haiyu immediately charged out. They continued to approach the Saint's Fruit, growing closer and closer. It's them. It's actually the dragon and the other magical beast that fought against the Path Lord of Carnal Desires and the Saint Emperors from the Beast God continent. Many people immediately recognized them, and they all spoke at once. They possess origin energy weapons that can injure Saint Emperors and origin energy armors that make it difficult for Saint Emperors to harm them. They also own a wondrous speed that protects their soul. They're relying on these three treasures, which is why they can survive the encirclement of so many vengeful spirits, a Saint King from an ancient clan said in envy. If I had those three treasures, I could kill a path through the vengeful spirits as well, some people thought inside. They struggled to hide their envy. The Saint's Fruit. That's the Saint's Fruit. Suddenly, someone cried out from the crowd and everyone glanced over immediately. They discovered an ordinary, little tree standing all by itself on the scarlet ground. It had 9 leaves, and between the leaves hung a fist-sized fruit. It no longer glowed since it had returned to how it was before. It was simple. Just like an ordinary piece of fruit. All the people gathered here originated from ancient organizations. The Saint's Fruit was recorded in great detail in the books at their clans, so they recognized it as soon as they saw it. All of their gazes began to burn with an urge. An extremely powerful desire to own it was ignited at the bottom of their hearts. The current world made it very difficult to reach Saint Emperor while the fruit was the only shortcut to become a Saint Emperor. No one could resist such a great temptation. At this moment, no one paid any more attention to Ruijin and the two others. The Saint's Fruit had drawn all of their attention, and the next moment, all the Saint Kings, regardless whether or not they were from the Protector clans or the Ancient clans, all charged toward the fruit as fast as they could with their eyes green with envy. Their movements immediately alerted a portion of the vengeful spirits around Ruijin and the others. Close to 200 vengeful spirits immediately broke from the group, blocking the Saint Kings as black streaks of light. The two sides immediately began to fight, erupting into an intense battle. Over 100 human Saint Kings ferociously clashed with over 200 Saint Emperor vengeful spirits. All the Saint Kings wanted to break free from the vengeful spirits as soon as possible to retrieve the Saint's Fruit, so they used everything they had. Various powerful Saint-tier battle skills and ancient secret techniques were used unceasingly. Tremendous energy ripples shook up the surroundings, almost destroying everything. Storms of energy whistled around, causing the mist in the death nest to churn. The two sides were actually locked in a stalemate. The vengeful spirits were extremely powerful when they were still alive, but their strength had decreased now. At the same time, the human experts knew powerful Saint-tier battle skills and ancient secret techniques. In a one-on-one situation, the Saint Kings could rival the vengeful spirits, unless a powerful existence like Gusties appeared. The pressure Ruijin, Honglian, and Haiyu were under immediately decreased. They let out a breath of relief inside and secretly thanked the 10 Protector clans. They thanked them for reducing the pressure they were under. At this moment, another group flew over from behind. They were the Saint Kings of the second wave. They did not possess ancient legacies, so they had no idea about the saint's fruit. However, since they could become saint kings, they were all intelligent people. They all knew that there was something inside that even the 10 protector clans would drool over. There's a small tree over there and there's a fruit on it. It's definitely an extremely valuable heavenly resource, the second group of people exclaimed when they saw the saint's fruit. The hearts of the people from the first wave sank. Shortly after the second group arrived, all of them in the first group quickly retreated, drawing the vengeful spirits back with them as they retreated to the second group. They pulled them into the battle as well. The vengeful spirits were no longer their opponent with the addition of the second group. They were suppressed by the joint attacks of the Saint Kings and many of the spirits collapsed. Over 200 more vengeful spirits broke away from the encirclement around Ruijin and the others. They aggressively surged toward the group of Saint Kings. With this, the vengeful spirits around the three of them immediately dropped to under 200. This allowed the three of them to rejoice. With their strength, they paved a path and quickly approached the fruit. The saint's fruit is a treasure of us humans. Don't you dare take it, you outsiders. Yi Yangtzai discovered what Ruijin and the others were doing, and he immediately fell into a rage. He roared out and immediately abandoned the vengeful spirits he was fighting. He charged toward the three of them with a few other experts of the protector clans in an attempt to stop them. You overestimate yourselves if you want to stop me, Hong Lian coldly said in disdain. A great stream of burning white flames immediately shot from her hairpin, enveloping Yi Yangtzai and the others. Yi Yangtzai's face changed, and he immediately dodged. However, a saint king at the 8th heavenly layer was a little too slow. The flames swept past his lower half and his legs began to burn. His flesh was burned to ash, but the terrifying white flames did not stop just there. Instead, it quickly spread to his upper half through his legs. Arg! The person shrieked out miserably. His lower half was disappearing bit by bit. The white flames contained unbelievable power. They could not be put out at all. This was the fire that came from the origin energy weapon. It was countless times stronger than what Hong Lian could control herself. Swish! With a flash, a saint king firmly struck out. He split his companion in half along the waist, which prevented the terrifying outcome of the flames spreading to his upper body. What terrifying flames! This stunned many saint kings. Many of them became fearful of the flames. How can you foreigners lay your hands on a sacred item of the humans? At this very moment, an ancient voice boomed out from the battle between the saint kings and vengeful spirits. Four ruddy old men sat in the middle of the air as wisps of mist enshrouded them. They seemed like immortals. More than 10 saint kings covered them, blocking the attacks from the vengeful spirits. It's the people of the Shengxiao sect. Looks like they're about to cast God's Heavenly Thunder. It's rumored that God's Heavenly Thunder is the supreme technique of the Shengxiao sect. It can draw in the heavenly thunder that resides above the nine heavens. A saint emperor was struck by it once, and he died on the spot. He was burned to a crisp. A few saint kings from ancient clans could not help but cry out. Chapter 1155, A Struggle Between the Strong. 5. At this moment, the four great elders from the Shengxiao sect became the center of attention. Many human experts watched them from the corner of their eyes as they fought with the vengeful spirits. The legendary God's Heavenly Thunder from the Shengxiao sect was a powerful secret technique that had already approached the limits of the saint tier and even exceeded other saint tier battle skills. It had reached a whole different domain that was even more profound. The secret technique had rarely been used through history since using it was exhausting and would bring about a powerful backlash. It was almost a forbidden technique, but once it was used, the power could be described as devastating. The four great elders sat together in the air. They all formed seals with their hands as the wisps of mist around them surged into the sky. They used the mist to resonate with the world and summon a mysterious and powerful energy from beyond the heavens. Crack! Suddenly, a deafening boom exploded. A huge bolt of lightning descended from the sky, falling toward Hong Lian with unbelievable speed. There were no dark clouds. It was a bolt from the blue. The sound of thunder filled the air and reverberated across the sky. The bolt of lightning glowed with extremely bright light, illuminating the surroundings. At that moment, The bolt of lightning seemed to have become the only thing in the world. Its blinding light made the sun darken. Hong Lian raised her head toward the sky. A stern light flashed through her eyes as she murmured, "Quite some trick, but it's still not enough to injure me." She had already been locked on by the lightning, so she could not dodge. All she could do was receive it head on. White flames roared around the scorching godfire hairpin before it was thrown into the air by Hong Lian. Immediately, it morphed into a 10-meter-long hairpin from its original size, turning into a white streak of light as it shot toward the god's heavenly thunder with an unstoppable force. Boom! The hairpin collided with the bolt of lightning and an extremely clear boom erupted. Terrifying waves of sound caused the ground to gently tremble. Many Saint Kings were deafened. The bolt of lightning had actually been shattered. The huge bolt of lightning had been smashed into countless smaller sparks that shot in all direction by the hairpin, so it seemed like the blooming of a beautiful flower in the sky. It actually created a rather special scene. What a powerful origin energy weapon. It actually destroyed the Shenxiao sect's absolute technique without any difficulty. The Saint Kings that saw this broke into a hubbub. Many of them even revealed greed in their gazes. They had become interested in such a powerful origin energy artifact. If they obtained it, they would be invincible below Saint Emperors, and they would have the abilities to contend against Saint Emperors as well. The four great elders of the Shenxiao sect all became rather ugly. Some paleness appeared on their faces. They remained silent, clenching their teeth to summon more bolts of lightning. Hong Lian did not give them the chance to continue. Roaring flames enveloped her as she shot toward the four of them with lightning-like speed, like the descent of a fire goddess. The Saint Kings that covered the four great elders all stepped forward. They sternly stared at Hong Lian and immediately struck out with a palm. Immediately, surging energy erupted toward Hong Lian with a great force. The scorching godfire hairpin immediately spat out a stream of terrifying white flames. The fire seemed to be able to melt everything in the world, and the energy sent out from over 10 Saint Kings was actually burned to a crisp by the fire. The flames had even spread along a sliver of their presence, tainting their arms. Their limbs immediately began to burn as their flesh slowly turned to ash. The Saint Kings all grunted. They could not put out the flames, so they all made a ruthless decision. They all severed their arms, which stopped the fire from spreading. Their severed arms were instantly burned to a crisp. There was no one obstructing Hong Lian now. They all feared the white flames, since once it got to them, they would lose a layer of skin even if they didn't die. Hong Lian aggressively continued toward the four great elders. Their expressions drastically changed. Without bothering with anything else, they used their final secret techniques to escape. With a wave of her hand, the scorching godfire hairpin immediately trembled. Four finger-sized sparks flew out, shooting toward the four great elders with lightning-like speed. Afterward, she collapsed two vengeful spirits that floated over in the surroundings using the hairpin again. Among the four great elders, one of them used a vengeful spirit beside him to block the spark. Another one was struck in the leg, while the two others were struck in the chest. The white flames immediately began to flare up, burning from their chests and quickly spreading in all directions. The three great elders all wailed out painfully. One of them severed his leg without any hesitation, while the heads of the other two exploded. They abandoned their bodies and their souls flew out. They quickly traveled toward the uninjured great elder before being sucked away into a gourd. Vast pressures descended from the sky. They brutally tried to crush Hong Lian, almost as if an invisible mountain was descending. Around a dozen Saint Kings in the surroundings had all begun to use Saint-tier battle skills, targeting Hong Lian. Some were from protector clans, while the others were ancestors of ancient clans. Hong Lian produced a clear phoenix's cry that was sent to the sky. The flames around her surged 10 meters high as several flame pillars as thick as an arm shot in all directions like scattered flowers. To no surprise, they targeted the Saint Kings who were using Saint-tier battle skills. If one observed carefully, it was not difficult to see that every single pillar of fire contained a long, fire-red feather. The flames all originated from the feathers. The situation had completely developed into a battle between three parties. One side included Ruijin, Haiyu, and Hong Lian, Another side included several hundred vengeful spirits, and the final side was the human Saint Kings. Hong Lian took on the attacks from many Saint Kings and vengeful spirits all by herself. She attracted the attention of all the Saint Kings. Many people from the Protector Clans and the Ancient Clans began to fight against Hong Lian. They feared her flames very much, but that did not mean they were afraid. The great elders from the Qingyang Clan became uncertain. They knew the connection between Jian Chen and Rui Jin, Hong Lian, and Hai Yu, so they were hesitating about treating them as enemies or not. They could not allow outsiders to take the saint's fruit since it belonged to humans. At this moment, Rui Jin and Hai Yu finally approached the saint's fruit under the encirclement of so many vengeful spirits. The saint artifact hidden in Rui Jin's bosom immediately flew out, and with a golden flash, Jian Chen silently appeared. He used the illusory flash and arrived before the saint's fruit in a single motion. Chapter 1156, Aura's Sand. Jian Chen had already arrived in front of the saint's fruit. With a flip of his hand, a supreme quality jade box appeared, and without any hesitation, he extended it toward the saint's fruit. Jian Chen is a person of the Qingyang Clan. A member of the Qingyang Clan has already approached the fruit. Everyone be careful. The Qingyang Clan is colluding with the foreigners. Many people discovered Jian Chen, who had already approached the fruit and was about to pick it. They immediately cried out in exasperation before attacking even harder. They did everything they could to finish off the vengeful spirits they were fighting so they could go and take the saint's fruit. The great elders of the Qingyang Clan had all rejoiced. Jian Chen's appearance had completely surprised them. They knew that Jian Chen was connected to Rui Jin and the others, but they never thought the relationship would be so deep, where the three of them were actually willing to help him obtain the fruit. Fantastic. This is fantastic. The saint's fruit belongs to our Qingyang Clan. Qingyang King Jueri was ecstatic. He seemed to have seen that a saint emperor would soon appear in the Qingyang Clan. The other great elders were the same. They showed no doubt in Jian Chen's abilities from their excitement. Jian Chen's actions pushed the battle to a climax. Everyone used 120% of their power so the fruit would not end up with someone else. They all traveled in the fruit's direction as they became blinded by greed. However, when the saint's fruit was about to fall into Jian Chen's jade box, another formation silently appeared. It formed a light screen around the fruit and protected it. A gleam of stern light flashed through Jian Chen's eyes. He immediately drew his emperor armament and began attacking the formation, but it was extremely powerful. He could not shake it even with his full strength. Both the humans and vengeful spirits had sustained great casualties. Several dozen Saint Kings had already become heavily injured, and three Saint Kings below the third heavenly layer had already passed away. Their souls had been wiped out by the vengeful spirits and all the vitality within them had been sucked away. The vengeful spirits also suffered great casualties. Many vengeful spirits collapsed plenty of times, and over 10 of them had turned into a dense black mist, no longer able to reform. On the other side, Tian Jian currently fought against gusties with the five veterans of Mercenary City, who were at the end of their lives, and two Saint Kings at great perfection from the Protector Clans. As the strongest Saint Emperor in ancient times, Gusties was terrifying even as a vengeful spirit. It took the combined force of eight Saint Kings at great perfection to merely stop him, and they had even vaguely fallen to a disadvantage. The five veterans of Mercenary City and the two Saint Kings at great perfection from the Protector Clans immediately began to panic when they saw that the saint's fruit was about to be taken. This vengeful spirit is just too powerful. If we keep fighting like this, victory won't be determined even after three whole days and nights. We can't continue like this. Quickly use the final trump card to finish off these vengeful spirits and then take the saint's fruit, a saint king from a Protector Clan yelled as he fought against gusties. With a flip of his hand, a scorching ball of light appeared. A brutal, flaming hot presence of supreme yang permeated the surroundings. With a wave of his hand, he immediately threw the light in his hands toward gusties like rain. Only then could the light be seen properly. It came from extremely tiny particles of sand, and each particle radiated with a burning golden light. The sand actually possessed the essence of the sun. As the sand touched Gusties, it appeared just like sparks landing in a vat of alcohol. Gusties actually caught fire and his rapidly weakened. "Don't hold back, everyone, or none of us will be getting the saint's fruit. Use the Ura's sand to deal with the vengeful spirits," someone called out from a group. He was a great elder from the Tyrant's Blade School. A few great elders from different protector clans hesitated when they heard the cry, but they soon made up their minds. With a flip of their hand, a similar ball of burning light immediately appeared as well. The essence of pure, supreme Yang appeared. A burning ball of light appeared in the hands of the ancestors from the ancient clans as well. They then reluctantly let it scatter into the vengeful spirits. The Ura's sand was an item invented by past saint emperors specifically for dealing with the vengeful spirits. They used meteorites as a material, grinding them into the consistency of sand before placing it in a location extremely close to the sun. They were only created after being refined by the flames of the sun for 1,000 years, and every single particle of sand had absorbed 1,000 years worth of the sun's flames. They were filled with the essence of the sun and were items of supreme Yang. They just happened to be the bane of the vengeful spirits. Even the protector clans possessed an extremely small amount of the Ura's sand. They were their final trump cards to deal with the vengeful spirits, and they would never be used so easily unless they absolutely needed to use them. This was because the sand could not be refined easily. Only saint emperors possessed the ability to get close to the sun, and a powerful formation that could resist the impact of the sun's fire needed to be set up so that the sand could move with the sun. This was not something any old saint emperor could achieve. The ancient clans in possession of this sand were all powerful existences that once had saint emperors. Light scattered through the air and the vengeful spirits immediately began to burn as soon as they came in contact with the light. The flames caused them to rapidly weaken. The human experts were originally in a disadvantageous position, but the situation changed as soon as the sand appeared. Instead, the vengeful spirits became suppressed. The vengeful spirits began to retreat in defeat. A few saint kings at great perfection abandoned their opponents and quickly flew toward the fruit. Gusties had been greatly weakened by the sand, and had retreated already. The five veterans from Mercenary City were free now, and they all looked at the fruit. Their eyes burned with a desire to own it, and they flew toward it in unison. Following them were the two other saint kings at great perfection who fought Gusties with them. "Wait, Ji and Chen possesses a very deep connection with our mercenary city, and his talent is extremely great. What you are doing will only ruin our relationship." Tianjian appeared before the five people from Mercenary City and obstructed them. The five old men did not waver because of this at all. One of them huskily replied, "Grand Elder, the five of us don't care about whatever connection you have with Jian Chen. We only know that once we obtain the saint's fruit, one of us will be able to become a saint emperor and let Mercenary City become even more glorious." Chapter 1157. A Powerful Existence. 1. The five old men from Mercenary City charged at Jian Chen in unison. Although Tianjian was the grand elder of Mercenary City, he was unable to stop them. The five of them possessed a special status in Mercenary City and were even older than Tianjian. They were his seniors. In other words, the situation of the vengeful spirits was disastrous. The Ura's sand posed too great of a threat to them. Once they came into contact with the sand, they would catch on fire immediately. They could not put out the flames at all, which caused their strength to rapidly weaken. Many vengeful spirits had retreated already, and some of them had even been beaten to the point where they could no longer recondense their bodies. They were greatly injured. Jian Chen was completely panic-stricken in front of the saint's fruit right now. It was surrounded by a powerful formation at level he could not break through. "Ziying, King Xiuo, is there any way to break through this formation?" Jian Chen seeked help from the sword spirits. "Master, this is a closed formation. There is no way in or out, so the only method to get through it is by destroying it with supreme force," King Xiuo said in Jian Chen's head. Beside him, Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Haiyu fought as hard as they could. Not only did they block vengeful spirits, Even some human saint kings had become their enemies, spatial gravity. Suddenly, someone yelled out. A great elder from a protector clan used an ancient secret technique from far away, which caused the gravity around Ruijin and the others to skyrocket. The three of them all slightly sank. At that moment, they felt like they had become over 1,000 times heavier, which had even caused the ground below them to sink. Even Jian Chen was affected. A gleam of stern light flashed through Ruijin's eyes. With a deep call, the sacred dragon's sword struck the space while glowing with a dazzling golden light. It caused the space there to violently shake, breaking through the ancient secret technique with supreme strength. As soon as the ancient secret technique was broken, a vast pressure descended from the sky again. There were Saint Kings casting Saint-tier battle skills, and the number of them had reached over 30. Ruijin flung out his hand and 18 palm-sized banners suddenly appeared. Every single banner shone with a hazy, golden light. Through the light, the banners could be seen covered in inscriptions and strands of powerful energy radiated from within. The 18 banners arranged themselves in the empty air and began to shine with a blinding light. The rays of light weaved together, actually forming a faint barrier of energy to protect them. The Saint-tier battle skills were used at the same time. Over 30 tremendous ripples of energy erupted and the extremely powerful attacks landed on the golden barrier almost at the same time, causing the barrier to violently shake. The barrier was not destroyed, but over 20 vengeful spirits who were attacking it were reduced to dark mist by the Saint-tier battle skills. Swish. The golden light disappeared with a flash. Ruijin knew that Jian Chen could not break through the formation protecting the fruit, so he stabbed at the formation with his sword. The formation around the fruit violently shook, but it stabilized once again. Ruijin's attack, which was no weaker than a blow from a saint emperor, was actually not enough to break through it. "Let's break through this formation together," Hai Yu growled. The origin energy weapon in his hand began to shine with a blinding white light as a mysterious and powerful origin energy coiled around the surface. Afterward, he struck the formation in unison with Ruijin. Ruijin and Hai Yu were both extremely careful. Although the origin energy weapons possessed tremendous strength, they could control it. As they swung down, they did not target the fruit, but the formation around it. They were afraid that they would destroy the fruit with even the slightest carelessness. The formation protecting the fruit was far more powerful than they had imagined. It did not shatter after withstanding the joint attack, and instead, it just trembled even more heavily. "Again!" Hai Yu roared out as a vast presence exploded from him. His clothes and long hair danced about despite the absence of wind, while the machete in his hand emitted an even more dazzling light. He struck the formation once again along with Ruijin's sword. This time, the formation finally shattered as it gave in. Without any hesitation, Jian Chen used the jade body to carefully collect the saint's fruit, before grabbing the 9 leaves as well. He stored the box away carefully. Jian Chen immediately exhaled a deep breath after he did all that. He gently rubbed his space ring as joy filled him inside. He had finally obtained the fruit as he had wished after so much effort. The barren, small tree quickly began to wither now that the fruit and 9 leaves had been removed. It shriveled up in the blink of an eye before disappearing into the earth. Boom! With a deafening rumble, the 18 small banners finally shattered from the violent attacks by the human saint kings and vengeful spirits. A great group of saint kings aggressively charged toward Jian Chen. "Hand over the saint's fruit!" many saint kings roared. They all seemed to have been peeved by the fact that Jian Chen had taken the saint's fruit, all falling into a rage. They could no longer bother with anything else. The enticement of the saint's fruit was just far too great. It was so great that even ancient clans dared to offend protector clans to obtain it, because this was their only chance to have a clan member become a saint emperor. Once they had broken through successfully, there would be no problems even if they had offended the protector clans, since they would then possess the ability to contend with the protector clans at that time. Chapter 1158, A Powerful Existence. 2. A devastating golden sword chi suddenly appeared. As a streak of light, it chopped through the air and traveled with an unstoppable force. The 100-meter-long sword chi enveloped all the human experts who were charging over, causing them to pale. At the same time, A huge silver blade of light shot through the air with lightning-like speed, chopping towards the human experts in another area. The surrounding temperature quickly rose as a terrifying waves of heat shot out. Roaring white flames suddenly leaped into existence, forming a terrifying wall of fire in the air. Countless experts were afraid of getting close to it. They all feared it. Ruijin, Honglian, and Haiyu attacked in unison. They faced enemies from all directions. With their origin energy weapons, they formed a tight defense, keeping countless Saint Kings at bay. Although the Saint Kings were not as powerful as the vengeful spirits, they possessed intelligence. They knew how to work with one another, and they knew many ancient secret techniques and Saint-tier battle skills. It was no easier to face them than the vengeful spirits. Faced up against Ruijin and Haiyu's attacks, all the Saint Kings immediately began to work together with a tacit understanding. They all sent their attacks at the sword Qi and Thr blade of light in unison. There were no Saint Emperors among the human experts, but attacks from several dozen Saint Kings, or even 100, were no weaker than one from a Saint Emperor. It even seemed to surpass the attack of a Saint Emperor. Even if Saint Emperors were present, all they could do was dodge. With two deafening booms, Ruijin and Haiyu's attacks from the origin energy weapons were blocked by all the Saint Kings. The origin energy weapons were powerful, but Saint Emperors could block them. The Saint Emperors would only become heavily injured if they were wounded by the origin energy. The human expert's confidence grew after blocking Ruijin and Haiyu's attacks. The fear within them was reduced as they all rushed forward. However, no one dared to touch Honglian's wall of fire, all detouring around it. There were fewer and fewer vengeful spirits now. The Eris Sand was very effective, bringing a radical change to the situation and killing off many vengeful spirits. It consumed all the spirits' energy so that they could no longer recondense, reduced to a dense, dark mist in the death nest. Only after countless years would they be able to recondense. Of course, a small portion of vengeful spirits had run away and avoided the disaster. The vengeful spirits were invulnerable in the death nest. Honglian, release the killing formation. Ruijin called out before immediately pulling out the formation he had prepared earlier. He tossed it out, and it activated in the air. Radiating with powerful ripples of energy, the space in a radius of 1,000 meters distorted. All the Saint Kings in the region disappeared, becoming trapped in the formation space. Honglian frowned and lamented, "We prepared these formations specifically for the vengeful spirits. We've changed many aspects and replaced them with methods to deal with the vengeful spirits. If we use it against these humans, the advantages of the killing formations will almost be non-existent. It won't be able to trap them for long." However, Honglian did not hesitate, even though that was what she said. She threw out a killing formation and trapped over 30 Saint Kings in it. Close to 100 Saint Kings had been trapped by the two killing formations, greatly reducing the pressure they faced. Haiyu possessed no formations. He killed his way into the groups of humans with his machete. As his blade fell, blood splashed everywhere. No one was Haiyu's opponent except for the Saint Kings at great perfection, and even they were unwilling to take Haiyu's attacks head-on. The Saint Kings were thrown into an utter mess by Haiyu. As Haiyu rampaged among them, it was very difficult for them to gather several dozen people to work together and use powerful attacks. Ruijin looked back at Jianchen and said, "These killing formations don't pose a great threat to the human experts. They'll break free very soon. Jianchen, follow behind us. We'll kill our way out." Jianchen sternly nodded. Their plan could only adapt to the changes. Originally, they had planned to get Taita to take them out after they had obtained the fruit, but there were too many human experts here now. Jianchen could only leave Taita in the Saint Artifact to protect his identity. Ruijin, Honglian, and Haiyu paved a path up ahead. They killed the Saint Kings that charged up, while Jianchen did not stand around either. He wielded the Emperor armament as he fought against 5 Saint Kings, 2 at the 7th heavenly layer and the rest at the 6th. The Saint Artifact hovered above his head, helping him block powerful attacks from time to time. The 4 of them had basically become public enemies in everyone's eyes. They received attacks from all directions, enduring constant barrages from various ancient secret techniques and Saint-tier battle skills. However, the attacks struggled to harm Ruijin, Hongliang, or Haiyu since they were clad in Origin Energy armor. The Saint artifact also helped Jian Chen block two Saint-tier battle skills as they moved. Behind the groups of people, five old men sat together in the air, casting a secret technique. They then pointed at Haiyu from afar and an extremely obscure ripple of energy expanded. It was very difficult to sense. Haiyu's face suddenly changed as he fought. A trail of blood flowed from the corner of his mouth, and he began to tremble a little. His face paled. "Haiyu, what's wrong?" Ruijin immediately asked when he sensed the abnormality of Haiyu. He was filled with shock. "It's poison. Supreme experts that are well versed with poison have secretly poisoned me. They've actually planted it directly into my body." "What great skills?" Haiyu explained in a heavy voice. His face had already darkened while the blood at the corner of his lips had turned black. Surprised, Jian Chen immediately arrived beside Haiyu. He used the Saint artifact to cover himself as he injected a strand of radiant Saint Force origin energy into Haiyu. Haiyu waved his hand and said, "It's not a problem. The poison's extremely powerful, but my body is no ordinary body. I can suppress it for a few days." Jian Chen also knew that right now was not the time to cure Haiyu from his poison. He said, "Senior Haiyu, when we leave here, I'll use the origin energy of Radiant Saint Force to completely cure you of the poison." Near the back of all the people, the five old men who had cast the poison stood up at the same time. One of them said to the five veterans from Mercenary City nearby, "We've already used the poison of Heaven's End to heavily injure one of them. It's about time you five get moving." The five old men from Mercenary City nodded. Without saying anything, they immediately stood in a pentagram formation. Immediately, five tremendous presences radiated from their bodies. They formed five pillars of energy which surged into the sky. The five old men had reached the great perfection of Saint King long ago. They had already arrived at the peak of their cultivation level. They were existences that were infinitesimally close to Saint Emperor and were extremely powerful. The five of them used an absolutely secret technique together. The commotion was so great that it alerted many people present, and they immediately glanced over. The Qingyang clan and the Grand Elder of Mercenary City remained in the distance. They never took part in the fight for the fruit. Seeing what the five old men were doing, Tian Jian gently sighed. He obviously knew what secret technique the five of them were using, but he was filled with helplessness since he could not go and stop them. At this moment, the presences of the five old men actually fused together. Their presences joined to become an even more terrifying presence where even their energy stacked together. It became a force that could even shake the world, causing many Saint Kings to tremble inside. "Saint Emperor, this is the overwhelming presence that only Saint Emperors can possess," some people exclaimed. The five old men had used a secret technique to pool their power together, actually reaching the power of a Saint Emperor. They had basically reached the level of a Saint Emperor through an alternate method, shocking many people present. The five old men were surrounded by a bright layer of white light as a tremendous, terrifying energy rippled in their surroundings. The five of them seemed to have come with the Grand Elder of Mercenary City. They seemed to be using an extremely powerful ancient secret technique, and they need time to charge it up even with their strength that has reached the utmost peak, a Saint King from an ancient clan said. He was deeply shocked that Mercenary City actually hid such unknown experts. At this moment, tremendous amounts of energy quickly condensed above the five old men. In the end, it transformed into a figure completely condensed from energy. Its facial features were clear-cut, and it seemed alive. It seemed just like an immortal. "Mo Tanyan. That's Mo Tanyan. It's the champion of the humans, Mo Tanyan. Just what is this powerful ancient secret technique? It can even condense Mo Tanyan's figure." Countless people cried out in amazement. At this moment, the Saint Kings all struggled to keep their composure even with their mental fortitude. Mo Tanyan was just far too well known. Even after a million years, Mo Tanyan remained a godlike figure in the hearts of a countless number of people. Not only was this because he was the savior of the human race, having repelled the invasion of the 100 races, But he was also a glorious legend among the humans. He was the only sovereign-like figure that had surpassed Saint Emperor as a human. Chapter 1159, A Powerful Existence, 3. Standing like an immortal, the might from Mo Tanyan deeply shocked all the experts present. Under Mo Tanyan's tremendous presence, many Saint Kings had even lost the will to resist. Ruijin, Hong Lian, Hai Yu, and Jian Chen were also alerted by the incomparable might, but they tried to break free. They all looked at Mo Tanyan's projection and became extremely stern. Mo Tanyan was projected by the five old men of Mercenary City using an absolutely secret technique. This was something that Mo Tanyan had left behind in the past, and it surpassed Saint-tier battle skills. However, the conditions for casting the technique were extremely arduous. Only Saint Emperors could use it. The five old men had only barely managed after fusing their strength using another secret technique. The secret technique was left behind specifically for Saint Emperors. There was no room for doubt over its power. Suddenly, Mo Tanyan's figure moved. He took a step forward and the entire place immediately shook. The casual step hid an unbelievable amount of power. At that moment, space seemed to freeze and time seemed to stop. The churning black mist in the death nest calmed down. Mo Tanyan seemed to become the only thing in the world. Then, the space beneath his foot immediately began to ripple in a terrifying fashion. This ripple spread toward Ruijin and the others like a sword, moving extremely quick. All the Saint Kings stopped whatever they were doing. Their attention was involuntarily drawn to Mo Tanyan. His simple-looking step contained the truths of the world. It used the energy of the world. Ruijin, Hai Yu, Hong Lian, and Jian Chen immediately felt like they were immobilized. They had been firmly trapped there by an invisible energy, only able to watch helplessly as the rippling space quickly approached them like a sharp sword. Suddenly, a powerful golden light appeared on Ruijin. His body rapidly expanded and a layer of densely packed golden scales covered his body. He had assumed a half-dragon, half-human form, using his supreme strength to break free. Coupled with a roar that could shake the heavens, the sacred dragon's sword had shot forward as a golden streak of light. Fusing with his sword, he stabbed at the rippling space as hard as he could. The two silently collided and did not produce a great explosion. The space only violently shook, becoming blurry and distorted. Everyone's senses were affected. The rippling from Mo Tanyan's foot vanished. It had been blocked by Ruijin, but Ruijin suffered as well. He was launched back, landing 1,000 meters away in a horrible condition. The light from the origin energy armor on his body had dulled by noticeable amount. With a clear phoenix's cry, Hong Lian also forcefully broke free as fire flashed through the air. She turned into a huge divine phoenix, radiating with scorching white flames. She used the scorching god fire hairpin to attack Mo Tanyan's figure. Mo Tanyan remained expressionless. He was not the real Mo Tanyan. He was only the result of a secret technique, one that had surpassed Saint-tier battle skills. He extended a finger and endless amounts of world force immediately gathered from outside the death nest. The world force actually condensed into a 5-meter-long finger in a short moment, and that finger then shot toward the hairpin with an unstoppable force. Boom! With a violent rumble, the origin energy weapon was knocked away by Mo Tanyan's finger while the finger dispersed at the same time. Caw! An elated phoenix's cry rang out while Hong Lian used her clan treasure to protect herself. Endless amounts of white flame surged toward Mo Tanyan, enveloping him along with the five old men that were hiding within the secret technique. She wanted to burn all of them to ashes. Mo Tanyan's figure gradually dulled. His presence also rapidly weakened. He was not the real thing and only a secret technique. Once the technique ran out of energy, he would disperse. Saint force circulated within the five old men's bodies, temporarily protecting them from the flames. However, they had become much paler, and their faces were filled with exhaustion. Arg! The five old men called out at the same time. They poured their three vital energies into Mo Tanyan's figure, allowing him to consolidate once more. Under the control of their mind, Mo Tanyan smashed a palm firmly onto Hong Lian. Bang! With a muffled sound, Hong Lian's huge body was blown through the air with her white flames. She was launched far away by Mo Tanyun's palm strike. Roar! A deafening dragon's roar rang through the sky. The tremendous dragon aura had enveloped virtually all of the Death Nest. Ruijin had completely assumed his original form, turning into a 100-meter-long golden divine dragon. His scales were lustrous and shined with a golden light. Mo Tanyun remained where he was without moving. He launched a palm strike at Ruijin from 1,000 meters away. The strike suddenly became several 100 meters wide in the air as it fell toward him. It clenched the dragon tightly to its palm. Great dragon roars rang out time and time again. Clenched in Mo Tanyun's hand, Ruijin was currently attacking as hard as he could, causing the palm to constantly shake. The five old men from Mercenary City all slightly trembled. They had already become pale white and exhaustion was spelled out on their faces. They needed to use their vital energies to cast the secret technique, and the longer they used THRM, the more vital energies would be consumed. They were already old men, so they could not last very long at all. He sure is worthy of being a king of the dragon. This golden divine dragon has yet to become a saint emperor, yet it already possesses such great battle prowess. It's not because our secret technique is not powerful enough, but because the dragon has origin energy treasures. The five old men gruffly came to a conclusion. Every single one of them possessed an ugly complexion, and one of them called out, "The golden divine dragon has already been trapped by us, while one of the other two magical beasts has been hit by the poison of heavens and from the heavens incense school. Only the divine phoenix is left. Everyone use your supreme secret techniques to keep her busy. The saint's fruit will belong to you without the three of them getting in the way." Many people became tempted. Other than the Qingyang clan, the one or two experts from the other eight protector clans and a few from the ancient clans all began casting their supreme secret techniques to trap Hong Lian. It was different from before, since they were not offensive secret techniques but techniques to entrap. They all knew that Ruijin and the others were protected by origin energy armors. No matter how powerful the attacks were, it would be difficult to injure them. The people from the Qingyang clan did not interfere. As soon as they did anything, it would be equivalent to becoming everyone's enemy. "I'd like to see whether you have the ability to trap me," the phoenix said in human tongue. Her eyes had already become completely red as roaring flames leaped about them. "Jian Chen, enter the artifact space." "Hi," you commanded Jian Chen. His complexion had already become very dark as black blood flowed continuously from the corner of his mouth. The poison was much more potent than he had imagined. At this moment, the entire place began to shake. The entire Death Nest seemed to violently tremble, causing to everyone to lose their footing. Closely after the trembling, a swath of extremely dense red mist appeared from the depths of the Death Nest. It seemed to be completely created from blood as the grudges of the dead and Yin Qi cowered away. "It's baleful Yin force. It's actually the baleful Yin force of the Bloodsaw Earth sect." "Impossible. How can there be baleful Yin force in the Death Nest?" Chapter 1160, The Blood Red Skeleton. A series of exclamations rang out. Disbelief flooded the faces of many people. The people from the 10 protector clans were affected in particular. They were all shocked inside. There were descriptive records of everything within the Death Nest in the 10 protector clans. All of the information originated from the countless times their ancestors had explored the land, and they had recorded everything about the place. However, the existence of baleful Yin force in the Death Nest had never been mentioned. There was only copious amounts of Yin Qi and grudges. "The baleful Yin force is a special secret technique of the Bloodsaw Earth sect." "Does that mean there is an expert of the Bloodsaw Earth sect cultivating here?" "That's impossible. I've met experts of the Bloodsaw Earth sect before. It's impossible for their baleful Yin force to appear here. And the energy that has just appeared is countless times more powerful." "What terrifying baleful Yin force. Even so far away, my soul is still affected. It feels like it's being siphoned away by the baleful Yin force." All the Saint King's expressions changed. They all stared at the extremely dense, blood-red mist in shock. The baleful Yin force did not approach them, but their souls were all affected anyway. This filled them all with deep shock. Tian Jian also became extremely stern. He stared at the baleful Yin force in interest and gruffly said, What powerful baleful yin force? It's actually several hundred times more powerful than Houston's. How was it created? If it originates from a person, then that person's strength would be too terrifying. Jian Chen stared at the cloud of baleful yin force unblinkingly. He thought inside, is Uncle Zhiyu cultivating here? Has he already become a saint emperor? Bang, bang, bang. Suddenly, muffled sounds reverberated from the depths of the death nest. The ground constantly trembled as a demonic, 100-meter-tall figure gradually emerged from the cloud of baleful yin force. All the saint kings became stunned when they saw the demonic figure's appearance. It was actually a 100-meter-tall skeleton. It was completely blood red, as if it had bathed in blood. It stood in the baleful yin force and actually seemed to be a part of it. The baleful yin force is from this skeleton, someone cried out from the crowd. With that, everyone immediately looked closer. Indeed, they discovered that the extremely dense baleful yin force was radiating from every single bone of the skeleton. The baleful yin force actually originated from the huge skeleton that had appeared out of nowhere. This made many people extremely surprised. The skeletons formed from countless bones of saint emperors. It's all from the experts that were buried here, another knowledgeable person cried out. What he said astounded every single saint king. How is this possible? How have the remains that Mo Tanyan buried all those years ago formed such a huge skeleton? Did someone do something to the death nest, which is why a huge skeleton has appeared here? The saint emperor ancestors of our 10 protector clans have searched the death nest many times in the past, but rarely did they ever come across the remains of saint emperors. Many of them had vanished, so they thought that Mo Tanyan had refined them through a huge formation. Looks like all the remains were hidden away instead. Who hid these remains? Was it Mo Tanyan? The ancestors of my clan were once confused about why Mo Tanyan created a place like this. It looks like Mo Tanyan did not just make this place for the saint's fruit. There's other secrets that we don't know about. Various discussions arose in the surroundings. The protector clans as well as some of the ancient clans knew many secrets regarding the death nest. All of them said whatever they knew, coupled with a few conjectures from other people. All of them immediately thought of a lot of things. The appearance of the giant skeleton had temporarily attracted everyone's attention. They had stopped fighting while many of them focused on the skeleton. At this moment, the blood-red skeleton moved. It extended one of its bony arms and an endless amount of baleful yin force immediately radiated from its bare bones. As a dense, red mist, it rolled toward everyone. Before the mist had even approached them, all the saint kings felt like their heads were splitting open as a stabbing pain appeared in their souls. At that moment, all of them seemed to lose control of their souls. All their souls wanted to fly out of their heads and fly over to the baleful yin force. All the saint kings were extremely shocked. The baleful yin force was just too terrifying. Even with their powerful souls, they struggled to withstand it. All the saint kings dared not stay any longer. They all retreated quickly as if they had seen a ghost. They all became filled with dread because of the baleful yin force. Jian Chen's soul was affected just like the other saint kings, but two powerful lights of violet and azure erupted in his sea of consciousness soon afterward. The sword spirits used their own strength to protect Jian Chen's soul. A bead appeared above Hong Lian and Hai Yu. It lit up with a hazy glow which protected their souls, allowing them to remain unaffected by the baleful yin force. The five old men from Mercenary City also stopped casting their secret technique. They quickly retreated like everyone. They were exhausted, so they avoided the advancing baleful yin force. It's a pity that using that secret technique consumes far too much energy. We don't have anything left to try other things with it, or we could try destroying that skeleton with the technique. One of them became dejected within. He felt rather helpless and regretful. Mo Tanyan's figure vanished after it lost their support, and Ruijin recovered his freedom. A golden light flickered on him as he loudly roared at the sky. The roar was filled with anger, but just when he wanted to charge at the five old men, his face suddenly hardened. He also discovered the change in the situation. Ruijin, let's leave here quickly. That skeleton is very troublesome. Hong Lian's voice rang in Ruijin's head. Hong Lian had assumed a human form already. Chapter 1161. an existence beyond Saint Emperor. The clouds of baleful yin force quickly rolled toward everyone. They reached where they were standing very soon. Ruijin had just broken free, so he had not started to run. The baleful yin force was extremely close to him already, less than 100 meters away, and the distance was rapidly decreasing. Ruijin's face abruptly changed. The baleful yin force had yet to enter his soul, but his soul was already feeling a violent, stabbing pain. He also felt extremely dizzy. The baleful yin force was so powerful that even Ruijin struggled to endure it. Ruijin became extremely stern. He was filled with shock. As a golden divine dragon, he was the king of dragons. He possessed a natural advantage of an extremely powerful body and soul. The baleful yin force had not even reached him, yet it was already affecting his soul this much. He found this difficult to accept. The origin energy bead appeared above his head and shined with a hazy light, coating his body. It protected his soul, and with its assistance, the discomfort of his soul was immediately purged. The bead was a treasure that could block all attacks targeting the soul. The baleful yin force was powerful, but clearly it was not enough to break through the treasure's defenses. Ruijin's eyes flickered with a golden light. He stared at the huge skeleton hidden within the baleful yin force before quickly arriving in front of Jian Chen. He stood with Hong Liana and Hai Yu. "What's up with this skeleton?" Ruijin gruffly asked. He had been trapped in Mo Tanyun's hand earlier, isolating him from the outside world. As a result, he had no idea what had just happened. "It appeared suddenly. No one knows why, but it's an enemy," Hong Lian explained in a heavy voice. "The baleful yin force is very terrifying. No one among the humans can withstand it. If they get caught in it, they'll die for sure. We better leave here quickly before anyone notices." "I suddenly feel like the death nest is much more complicated than it seems," Hai Yu said with a frown. He was stern. All the human Saint Kings were rapidly retreating. They avoided the baleful yin force. The horror of the baleful yin force had scared many people witless, and only a few of them were still thinking about the Saint's fruit. "Xianger, we can't stay here. Let's leave quickly." Qing Yang Qingyan suddenly appeared by Jian Chen's side and warmly spoke in concern. Jian Chen frowned slightly as a sliver of undetectable coldness flashed through his eyes. He did not pay any attention to Qing Yang Qingyan, directly ignoring him. Qing Yang Qingyan had used the time when he was removing Huang Luan's ancient secret technique to plant another one of his own. His actions made Jian Chen extremely furious inside, and he had already begun to treat Qing Yang Qingyan as an enemy. "Let's go," Ruijin growled before grabbing Jian Chen's arm and retreating to the outskirts. The baleful yin force spread very quickly, but it was still slower than the speed at which the Saint Kings could fly. With their retreat, they immediately pulled far away from the baleful yin force. They were just about to leave the third zone of the death nest. At this moment, the blood-red skeleton roared at the sky. There was no sound, but a visible ripple expanded into the surroundings. Every single bone on its body churned with endless amounts of baleful yin force, actually causing the mist to clump together. It seemed to have become a sea of blood. Copious amounts of baleful yin force surged into the ground, causing the blood-red soil to become even brighter. At the same time, the ground began to shine with a faint red glow. The third layer of formations in the death nest was originally only used to separate the vile energies between the two zones. It could not obstruct the entry and exit of people, but it was suddenly activated at that moment. It formed a layer of red mist that surrounded the third zone, preventing any human experts from leaving. "How is this possible? The skeleton can actually control the formations here. Weren't they cast down by Mo Tanyun all those years ago? How can it control them at will?" "Looks like this skeleton has already developed a basic form of intelligence. It is much more complex than it seems. It's using baleful yin force to activate these formations, or maybe using the formations to allow the baleful yin force to gain another wondrous effect. We can't leave." Everyone worked together to smash the formation together. Many Saint Kings immediately launched powerful attacks at the formation. However, it had been cast down by Mo Tanyun all those years ago. Even after countless years, it remained as powerful as before. It was not something a group of Saint Kings could smash through, so the formation did not even budge no matter how hard they struck it. Ruijin, Hong Leon, and Haiyu struck out as well. They used their origin energy treasures to attack the formation in unison, but their attacks only made it shake. It was not enough to break through. The ground shook constantly as the skeleton approached them all, step by step. Its feet were like mountains, and every time a foot fell, the ground would violently shake. The dense baleful yin force would roll over from in front, getting nearer and nearer to all of them. All the humans fell into a panic. The baleful yin force was basically the Grim Reaper's scythe to them. It could ignore any Saint Force defenses and injure the souls of people. Even though many of them knew ancient secret techniques, they possessed no methods of dealing with the baleful yin force. "Are we all really going to die today?" someone wailed. He could already taste regret. "God damn it. How did this skeleton appear here? Why has it never appeared in countless years? And why does it have to suddenly appear in this age when there is a lack of Saint Emperors?" Some experts of the Protector Clans were confused and filled with questions. The appearance of the skeleton had become a mystery to all of them. Jian Chen also became unprecedentedly grim. He stared at the blood-red mist up ahead and said, "These people can all die here. The Tianyu on continent cannot sustain a loss like this. Seniors, are you able to destroy this skeleton?" "The baleful yin force does not affect us, so we can try," said Ruijin. Afterward, he went up with Hong Leon and Haiyu to fight the skeleton together. But the power of the skeleton was far beyond anyone's expectations. The three of them attacked the skeleton using their origin energy weapons, but all that was left behind was a shallow mark. The attacks that were powerful enough to harm Saint Emperors could not even break one of the skeleton's bones. At this moment, a red light flashed by. A huge bone club had appeared in the skeleton's hands at some point, sweeping toward Ruijin and the others. Bang, bang, bang. With three muffled sounds, the three of them were blown away by the skeleton's swing. Their origin energy armor had dulled as well. All the experts present became utterly stunned by what had just happened. All of their mouths hung agape as disbelief flooded their faces. They understood the three magical beasts' strength extremely well. They possessed the power to rival Saint Emperors, yet they could not even withstand a single blow from the skeleton. "It's beyond a Saint Emperor. The skeleton already possesses strength at the level of the four champions from ancient times," a great elder of a Protector Clan cried out. His voice trembled as horror filled him. With that, everyone paled. Despair filled all of their eyes. Chapter 1162, A Mysterious Expert. 1. Ruijin, Hong Leon, and Haiyu returned to Jian Chen's side with sunken faces. Their expressions were rather pale. Although they had been protected by their origin energy armor, the blood-red skeleton was just far too powerful, so they had still suffered some light injuries. "This skeleton possesses a strength beyond Saint Emperor. Even the three of us cannot stop it. If we end up in a long battle with it, we'll end up heavily injured," Ruijin said in a heavy tone of voice. All the Saint Kings heard what Ruijin had said, and they all became extremely grim. They all knew that the trio were Saint Kings at great perfection, but their real strength belonged to the level of a Saint Emperor. They were the most powerful present, so if they could not deal with the skeleton, no one could. "Beyond Saint Emperor. Beyond Saint Emperor. Legend has it that the strength beyond Saint Emperor belongs to a whole different level. The difference that exists between it and Saint Emperor is as wide as a chasm. It's completely impossible to make up for, because it's power that belongs to a different level," a great elder of a Protector Clan said with a trembling voice. Death and despair filled his eyes. Saint Emperors were like ants before those who had surpassed Saint Emperor, let alone them who were nowhere near Saint Emperor. "The way out has already been sealed up by this skeleton. We're all going to die here today. My clan still needs my protection. Without us, my enemy clans definitely won't let them off. Looks like my clan will be in for a disaster. It doesn't matter if I die. What does matter is that the Tianyu on continent still requires our protection, or we won't have enough power to fend off the invasions of the Beast God continent and hundred races." Everyone sighed in despair. Many of them were filled with an unwillingness to just die here like this. During this period of time, Jian Chen had also let out the White Tiger, but to his dismay, The Tigers' ability to ignore formations and barriers were completely useful here. It could no longer pass through them like before. At this moment, Ji and Chen thought of what Tai Ta had said in the past. His mysteries of war could break through the limitations of space, so he hesitated to try out Tai Ta's method or not, to see if his mysteries of war could take them all out. Just as Ji and Chen wanted to release Tai Ta, the entire death nest shook violently. With a great boom, the formation around the third zone shook violently, vaguely showing signs of shattering. Afterward, a second and third boom rang out close after each other. They caused the formation to shake more and more violently. Then it actually cracked open to everyone's disbelief. A 10-meter-wide crack appeared. At this moment, the baleful Yin force was already less than 1,000 meters away from them. Once they were caught by the blood-red mist, even they, Saint Kings, would not be able to survive, as it was countless times more terrifying than what Houston could control. "Run!" Someone roared from the crowd, and the mighty Saint Kings all fled outside as fast as they could. At this moment, the only thing they all thought about was fleeing. They never bothered to consider how the crack had appeared. The blood-red skeleton became utterly enraged and roared angrily. It quickly charged after all the people as it swung its bone club. The moment the club fell, it became several thousand meters long, smashing the Saint King at the very back to pieces. Even his soul failed to escape, shaken to parts by the terrifying force. The skeleton swung its club again. The scarlet bone became enveloped by a dense layer of baleful Yin force and fell with lightning speed. It loomed over around a dozen Saint Kings. Suddenly, a resplendent streak of light appeared. It illuminated the space and purged the endless amounts of Yin Qi and grudges of the dead in the death nest. It shot over with unbelievable speed. It was an extremely terrifying blade of light, shaped like a crescent moon. It shined with blinding light, and it seemed to break through the limitations of space. It was still very far away, but the next moment, it had already swept over the heads of all the Saint Kings with sharp blade chi. It struck the bone club with an unstoppable, domineering force. Boom! As soon as the blade of light clashed with the bone club, a deafening boom erupted. Powerful ripples of energy wreaked havoc within the death nest as terrifying storms caused all the Saint Kings to stumble and lose their balance. The club had been blocked by the blade of light, saving the lives of over 10 Saint Kings. The skeleton also stumbled a few steps back as its body shook. A terrifying crack had appeared on the huge bone club in its hands. All the Saint Kings had left the third zone by now. They arrived in the second zone, but none of them continued on. Instead, they could not help but stop and stare in the direction of the skeleton and blade of light in shock. Who was it who secretly attacked? He can actually deal such a powerful attack to deal with the frightening skeleton. If I've seen correctly, that flash of white light before was a huge blade of light. Who was the one responsible for that? This is a power that surpasses Saint Emperor. The senior who delivered that blade of light before must have stepped into that supreme domain. Impossible. Does that mean that there are still experts like that among us humans? That's definitely impossible. There were the four champions during the ancient times, but a fifth one has never appeared on our continent. W was it a sovereign-like figure of the Arctic Ice Goddess Hall who secretly interfered? Yes, it must be someone from the mysterious Ice Goddess Hall. They may have never interfered with the matters of the continent, but they must have been unwilling to see so many experts of the Tianyu on continent die here. I don't believe it's the Ice Goddess Hall. They don't have a sovereign-like existence. It must be the Sea Goddess who's done it, as she's the only one still alive out of the four ancient champions. A hubbub broke out among the people. Someone who had surpassed Saint Emperor had actually helped them out in secret when they were utterly doomed. This was an inspiring piece of information, filling everyone with emotion. It offered a path of escape to all of them, giving them new hope. The blood-red skeleton became even more angered. Baleful Yin force churned violently and was endlessly poured into the ground. Immediately, streaks of blinding red light radiated from the ground. They crisscrossed and wove together. It was actually a formation hidden beneath the ground which had been activated by the skeleton's baleful Yin force, allowing it to appear. The formation was activated and the endless amounts of vile energies in the third zone seemed to be affected. They all began to bubble violently in the air and, under everyone's disbelief, the yin chi fused with the grudges formed a cloud of blood-red baleful yin force. I finally understand. The baleful yin force must have been created from the fusion between the two vile energies. Everything's due to the formation yin under the ground. The two energies only fuse when the formation is activated. The death nest was created by Mo Tanyan all those years ago. Does that mean he left behind the formation in the ground as well? Why did he do something like that? Many people reached a conclusion, but they soon became even more confused. They all felt curious as to why Mo Tanyan had created a place like this. The saint's fruit definitely was not the main reason. Perhaps, it was only a pretense. The two energies fused together and formed even more baleful yin force. The fusion had virtually drained all the vile energies in the third zone with only a cloud of blood-red mist churning about. Soon afterward, the baleful yin force formed a huge, terrifying, and ferocious ghost's face that charged toward all of the Saint Kings with brandished claws and teeth. With a flash of blinding light, the resplendent blade of light appeared once again. Filled with a domineering force, it flew over from the first zone and struck the dense cloud of baleful yin force. The collision of the two actually knocked back the mist that all the Saint Kings fierced. The blade of light continued on without weakening at all, slicing through the mist and landing on the skeleton. Boom! With a deafening sound, a slash that was several dozen meters in length appeared on the skeleton. Some of its tough bones had been cleaved in half by the attack as it stumbled backward with its huge body. It only managed to stabilize itself after taking around a dozen steps back. The Saint Kings in the second zone all became stunned. Just a long-ranged blade of light was enough to force back the skeleton that had surpassed Saint Emperor. Just how powerful was that person? An existence like that had exceeded everyone's imagination. Some of them even refused to believe that there was such a terrifying expert hiding in the world. Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Haiyu all became shocked as well. They could obviously feel how terrifying the blade of light was. Even with their origin energy weapons, they could not deal attacks on that level. He's truly surpassed Saint Emperor. I wonder who he is, Ruijin gruffly said. Chapter 1163, A Mysteries Expert, 2. The blood-red skeleton that had frightened countless Saint Kings in the Death Nest was blocked by a mysterious expert. Although this expert never revealed himself, everyone knew just how terrifying he was. He was able to stop the skeleton that possessed strength beyond Saint Emperor from afar without even appearing. The skeleton was extremely angry. The dense baleful yin force around it violently churned, surging out time and time again. However, it was forced back by a blade of light that even the skeleton itself could not block. More and more cracks appeared on its body and a few bones were even broken. A few resplendent blades of light swept past and forced the surrounding yin chi and grudges of the dead to the sides. Slivers of domineering and terrifying blade chi remained there, actually causing the path paved between the vile energies to remain temporarily. Many people moved at this moment. Many Saint Kings had already begun traveling in the direction the blades of light originated from, wanting to see just who the mysterious expert was. Their movement immediately spurred on everyone else present. They immediately shot off in the same direction with lightning speed. The identity of this mysterious expert weighed on many people's minds. Jian Chen and the others were not exceptions either. They all followed the group in the direction of the blades of light. They passed through the second zone with lightning-like speed and arrived in the first. As soon as they made it there, everyone immediately jumped. A suffocatingly powerful blade chi filled the entire space. The blade chi seemed to have infected the air, making the air there feel sharp. A blinding white light stood over 10 kilometers in front of them. It was as dazzling as the sun, illuminating the entire first zone of the death nest. It was endless amounts of blade chi. The white light was completely formed from mighty blade chi, and looking closely, it was not difficult to discover that the light seemed like a huge blade. It was 100 meters tall. It's a balda, someone murmured in amazement. In that moment, Everyone focused their attention on the blade. It was just a pity that the blade was covered by blade chi, so it was blurry and unclear. The great elders of the Tyrant's Blade School stared at the blade's figure without blinking at all. A gleam of light flashed through their eyes as doubt and surprise crossed their faces. At this moment, the blade chi that filled the entire first zone quickly weakened. The white light also quickly darkened, and in just a few seconds, the figure of the giant blade suddenly disappeared. It returned peace to the death nest. What's up with this blade? Was it secretly controlled by a sovereign-like figure? Or was it all because of formations? In my opinion, it's extremely likely that this was from formations. It's definitely what Mo Danyun left behind all those years ago. A few Saint Kings immediately began making guesses. Some people believed that there was a great person secretly behind the blade, while others were certain it came from a formation, something Mo Danyun had set up all those years ago. The ground began to shake. The blood-red skeleton had passed through the formation and was pursuing them. The blood-red mist around it surged into the sky, and the baleful yin force it radiated was even denser than before. The Saint Kings no longer dared to stay any longer now that the blade had disappeared. They left as quickly as they could. As soon as Jian Qin's group flew out of the death nest, Ruizhen began constructing a space gate. However, as soon as it formed, several terrifying attacks flew in from all directions, shattering the gate. "Hand over the saint's fruit, or you won't be leaving here," a great elder from a protector clan called out. His presence quickly skyrocketed. He seemed like a whole different person when he fled earlier. Without the threat of the blood-red skeleton, everyone focused their attention on the saint's fruit again. Over 200 Saint Kings surrounded Jian Qin and the others. The atmosphere became utterly nerve-wracking. The great elders of the Qingyang clan stood to one side with ugly expressions. They were extremely worried, but they did not stand up and help Jian Qin. World of Feathers. Suddenly, Hong Lian cried out. The armor on her began to disassemble once more, turning into countless phoenix feathers to form a huge cage around them. Every single feather burned with intense white flames, preventing the Saint Kings from approaching them. "If you want the saint's fruit, then use everything you have," a Saint King cried out. Many Saint Kings stepped forward and used various Saint-tier battle skills and powerful ancient secret techniques to barrage the world of feathers. The temperature within the feathers was extremely hot as well. Even the space distorted slightly. Hong Lian did everything she could to maintain the defense as she said, "Ruizhen, quickly create a space gate." The battle skills and secret techniques these people know are too powerful. "They're not much weaker than the Saint Emperor Vengeful Spirits, so I can't last too long. The space in here is affected by the flames. It's become very unstable, so creating a space gate will be rather difficult." "I'll try my best," said Ruizhen before swinging his hand. The space in front of him immediately split open, but the space gate did not form as quickly this time. Ruizhen's arm was extended in the crack. The profound truths of the world were present on his hand. He was using a Saint King's ability to create space gates. Outside the feathers, a 100-meter-long hand suddenly fell from the sky. With a deafening boom, the hand viciously struck the feathers, causing them all to tremble violently. Chapter 1164, The Human Saint Emperor Appears. The sudden hand stunned all the Saint Kings who were attacking the feathers. They all raised their heads in doubt and surprise. The palm strike was extremely powerful. It was on par to an attack from gusties. But more importantly, many Saint Kings felt an extremely powerful ripple of the mysteries of the world within it. It was at a level Saint Kings could not achieve. "It's a Saint Emperor. There's a Saint Emperor who's joined us," an ancestor of an ancient clan growled. His complexion was rather horrible. He still had a sliver of a chance at obtaining the Saint's fruit when he contended against the protector clans, but he had no chance at all once a Saint Emperor interfered. "It's him, the Path Lord of the Carnal Desires. He's interested in the Saint's fruit as well," a Saint King cried out. He stared at the sky with much interest. In the empty sky, a white-robed, middle-aged man had already appeared at some certain time. He levitated in the air like a normal person and looked down on everything. An ill paleness was present on his evil-looking face. He was indeed the Path Lord of the Carnal Desires. Although he had appeared under an extremely low profile, he made people feel like he controlled the world as he hovered in the sky. Hong Lian's face changed within the feathers. She heavily said, "The human saint emperors come. If he works with the human saint kings, the feathers will be broken through in an even shorter amount of time." Ruijin said nothing. He was very stern, putting everything he had into creating a space gate, but the space within the feathers had become very unstable due to the terrifying heat. The Path Lord stared sharply at the huge ball of fire constructed from countless phoenix feathers. Afterward, he slowly raised his hand and the surrounding energy of the world immediately began to move violently. Endless amounts of world force condensed in his hand at an unbelievable rate. Fusion of the seven emotions, Palm of Severance. The Path Lord said with an extremely ordinary voice. He shot it down with that. Immediately, the vast amounts of world force condensed in his hand surged forward. It formed an invisible palm, flying toward the world of feathers with tremendous force. The surrounding energy was quickly absorbed as it flew, merging into the invisible palm and making it even more powerful. Not only was the palm a full-powered attack from a saint emperor, it contained the Path of Carnal Desires from the Path Lord. The strike collided against the feathers, but it did not manage to destroy the defense. The surging energy and world force dissipated, but an invisible ripple passed through the feathers and entered the space inside. This was the Path of Desires created by the Path Lord. It was not just a simple energy attack, but a special method to injure the souls. Ruijin, Haiyu, and Hong Lian were all protected by their beads, so they did not fear the Path Lord's method of attacks. Haiyu hovered above Jian Chen, using the hazy light to block the attack for Jian Chen. However, the space within the feathers was impacted by the attack, causing the space itself to violently shook. In other times, the shaking space would not have affected them at all, but Ruijin was currently constructing a space gate. What they feared most was unstable space. Just as the space gate was about to be completed, it suddenly collapsed and reduced Ruijin's efforts to nothing. God damn it. That bastard's actually come to make trouble right now. Once I break through to class 9, he'll be the first one I kill. Ruijin became enraged. Killing intent bubbled around him as he became ready to kill. The Path Lord of Carnal Desires' palm strike had locked them out of the thought of leaving easily. A gleam of light immediately flashed through the eyes of the Path Lord when he saw that his palm strike actually failed to achieve the intended results. He murmured, "They sure are worthy of being origin energy treasures. They're actually so powerful, but maintaining the defenses must drain you heavily. I'd like to see just how long you can last." "The saint's fruit will be mine today. Probably only it can cure me of my wounds." With that, the Path Lord continued to attack the barrier of feathers. Every single strike of his possessed extremely great might and would cause an earth-shaking commotion. Just by himself, he basically controlled all the world force in the radius of several tens of kilometers. He could use it all to deal devastating attacks with just a raise of his hand. The space within the feathers was reduced to utter chaos from the Path Lord's continuous attacks. Even with Ruijin's strength, he could not construct a space gate. "This can't continue. I've expanded too much energy." "Ruijin, Haiyu, you two pave a path of blood. We'll make them pay with blood this time." Hong Lian ground her teeth with a pale white face. Cold killing intent had appeared in her eyes. Although the three of them had heavily injured a few human experts in the death nest before, they had held back and did not slaughter them. However, the bitter resistance had already ignited her killing intent. "Hong Lian, work with Haiyu to take Jian Chen away. I'll go test out the human saint emperor," Ruijin heavily said. His irritation for the Path Lord had reached a point of resentment as well. Hong Lian nodded before looking toward Haiyu. She asked in concern, "Haiyu, can you endure it?" Haiyu's situation had clearly worsened. Not only did his face turn pale, even his arms has blackened. Blood flowed constantly from the corner of his lips. "This poison sure is powerful. It's probably much more terrifying than the poison that's ranked first in the world. But I'm still a Saint King at great perfection. Poisoning me to death isn't that easy, Hiyu said in an extremely gruff voice. Senior Hiyu, once we get to safety, I'll immediately use my Radiant Saint Force Origin energy to purge your poison, Jian Chen said. Suddenly, the feathers collapsed and countless huge feathers shrank back to finger length, shooting through the air as red streaks of light toward Hong Lian. Hong Lian's armor reassembled. I was right. You indeed cannot last for very long. You've finally been forced out by me. Now hand over the Saint's Fruit. I won't make it difficult for you. The Path Lord's voice rang out from the sky. He seemed extremely nonchalant. He knew that Ruijin and the others were protected by Origin Energy armors, but he continued to act like victory was in his grasp. A resplendent golden sword chi was what he received as a response. Clad in the sacred dragon's armor with the treasured bead hovering above his head, Ruijin aggressively charged over with his sacred dragon sword. The Path Lord showed nothing, but an undetectable sliver of fear still appeared in the depths of his eyes. He dared not to take the sword chi condensed from Origin Energy head-on, so he used World Force to disperse it. Although Ruijin possessed the Origin Energy treasures, he was not an expert of the Origin Realm. All he could do was make Saint Emperors fear him. He was unable to suppress three Saint Emperors with supreme force like Zhao Ling. Ruijin kept the Path Lord busy as Hong Lian and Haiyu conducted a slaughter beneath. This time, they did not hold back at all and fought as hard as they could. Very soon, a few weaker Saint Kings died to their hands. They died immediately since their souls failed to escape, and around a dozen other Saint Kings were also heavily injured. However, they were either saved by companions at a crucial moment or fled using secret techniques. The five old men from Mercenary City looked at each other and a sliver of determination appeared in their eyes. One of them said, "Whatever, we won't take the Saint's Fruit then. We're about to return to the Earth soon anyway, so why not use our last bit of vitality to cast the absolute secret technique again? We can leave the fruit to someone talented in Mercenary City." "Yeah, even if we die, we can't die in vain," the four other old men agreed. At that moment, all five of them had made up their minds about their deaths. Chapter 1165, Gathering of Four Saint Emperors. The five special old men from Mercenary City began to cast their absolutely secret technique again. Since they had consumed a lot of vitality when they had cast the technique the first time, they could be described as close to the end of their lives. They did not have much vitality left, and their lives could be extinguished at any moment. They had reached their final moments, so casting it this time was much more difficult than the first. Just the time they spent charging up was much longer than before. Jian Chen killed through the crowd with Haiyu and Hong Lian. He pushed his strength at the seventh heavenly layer of Saint King to the maximum, seemingly able to challenge an eighth heavenly layer Saint King. The Saint artifact hovered above his head, blocking powerful attacks from the ninth heavenly layer of great perfection from time to time. Even though that was the case, he was covered in blood. There was his own blood, as well as his opponent's blood. He was littered with wounds, but his strength remained the same and his presence was mighty with his tough chaotic body. Ruijin and the Path Lord of Carnal Desires' fight was extremely intense. Both of their strengths had reached the apex, so every clash was devastating. Their battle high up the sky had gradually risen to the icy and dark outer space. Hong Lian, Haiyu, and Jian Chen had already charged out of the Saint King's encirclement. At this moment, Hong Lian's armor disassembled again and turned into 100-meter-long feathers that burned with endless white flames. It formed a huge wall of fire in the air, obstructing the human Saint Kings. "I'll stop them. Haiyu, leave with Jian Chen first." Hong Lian maintained the wall of fire as she turned and gave an order to Haiyu. Haiyu nodded and did not add anything extra. He immediately grabbed Jian Chen by the arm and flew into the distance. He wanted to find some stable space to create a space gate and leave. His condition was even more severe than before. If he did not get it under control in time, he would probably become doomed. Leave won't be that easy. At this moment, A sneer rang through the space nearby. The space several hundred meters ahead rippled slightly and two burly men suddenly emerged. The appearance of the two people caused Jian Chen and Hai Yu's facial expressions to drastically change. Hai Yu stared at them with an ugly expression and growled, "Rulers of the Beast God Continent, I never thought even you two would come." The two people were Kaiser and the Tiger Emperor, but compared to last time, they were both distinctly pale. Kaiser stared at the saint artifact above Jian Chen for a while and a gleam of light flashed through his eyes. He sneered, "Hand over the saint's fruit and we won't make things difficult for you." Jian Chen put the saint artifact away. The white tiger was currently hiding within it, so he needed to remove all possibilities of Kaiser stealing the saint artifact. Afterward, with a flip of his hand, a ruined divine hall appeared. It was the Octodera divine hall that had been smashed to pieces by Kaiser before. The divine hall had always been repairing itself, but it was rather slow, so it only seemed to be in a little better shape than before. It could still withstand a few attacks from Saint Emperors, however. Looks like the lesson from the barrier spirit of Mercenary City still wasn't enough. Do you still want to suffer the same outcome as well? A sliver of fear flashed through the very depths of Kaiser and the Tiger Emperor's eyes when they heard him mention the barrier spirit. They had already developed a fearful mentality for the barrier spirit since it was an existence that had truly surpassed Saint Emperor. However, Kaiser's eyes turned icy once again without much time. He coldly said, "We were too close to Mercenary City last time, which was why we disturbed the barrier spirit. It's very far away from Mercenary City here, so it's impossible for the barrier spirit to come here. You better give up on the thought of relying on it." The terrifying temperature from behind suddenly disappeared. Hong Lian had re-equipped the 9 refined godfire feather mail. She was coated in terrifying white flames as she then charged toward Kaiser as a white streak. She did not pay any attention to the human experts behind. The two Saint Emperors of the Beast God Continent were far more terrifying than them, and she knew it would be very difficult to escape once they got near Jian Chen. Hai Yu clenched his teeth. Even though he was heavily poisoned, he had no other choice right now. All he could do was reluctantly charge up with his machete and keep the Tiger Emperor busy. A dragon's roar rang across the sky. Ruijin had noticed the situation below as he fought against the Path Lord and immediately abandoned his opponent to return. He shot through the sky as a dazzling golden streak of light. Just like a comet, he quickly made his way to the ground. "Golden Divine Dragon, our battle is still not over." The Path Lord also used his Saint Emperor abilities, moving faster than Ruijin. He first blocked Ruijin before striking with a handful of vast energy. He stopped Ruijin from providing assistance. "Path Lord, you're actually working with the experts of the Beast God Continent." Ruijin immediately understood the truth behind the matter with some thought. His face became extremely dark. The Path Lord said nothing. He used everything he had as the Saint Emperor to keep Ruijin busy. They went back to outer space and neither of them could overcome the other. Jian Chen did not pay attention to the battles of Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Hai Yu. He immediately used the illusory flash, flying off into the distance as fast as he could. He could only depend on himself now. Kaiser and the Tiger Emperor sneered at the same time as they watched Jian Chen leave. Kaiser steadily questioned, "Kang Gian, you're still not going to start moving? The sooner you take it, the sooner we can get back." Another figure appeared in the empty air. It was a white-clothed old man whose silver hair danced in the wind. He possessed an otherworldly charm and seemed to possess the presence of an immortal. The third Saint Emperor of the Beast God Continent had come to the Tianyuan Continent as well. With all three of them present, only the greatest powers of the 10 protector clans could stop them. All the human experts' expressions changed, becoming ashen. All three Saint Emperors of the Beast God Continent had gathered here and the human Saint Emperor had switched sides, working with them to steal the saint's fruit. What other power did they have to face them? Is the saint's fruit going to end up with the magical beasts this time? A feeling of powerlessness engulfed many saint kings from the protector clans and the ancient clans, coupled with a deep disgrace. The saint's fruit was a sacred item of the humans, and it had always been consumed by humans since ancient times. It had never been taken away by magical beasts. It would become an unredeemable disgrace etched into history if the saint's fruit ended up with the magical beasts. King Gian levitated in the sky as he looked at Jian Chen's back. A gleam of light flickered in his eyes as he hesitated. The saint's fruit has actually been obtained by him. He's the person who's looked after the winged tiger god for so many years. He's the winged tiger god's savior. So do I lay my hands on him or not? Do I let him take the fruit and let him reach Saint Emperor? Or do I take the fruit so that Kaiser and the Tiger Emperor can heal up? At this moment, a vast presence appeared far away. It was as powerful as a Saint Emperor's, and actually momentarily drew the attention of the three beast god continent experts. After charging up for so long, the five old men from Mercenary City finally used the absolutely secret technique again. The five of them poured their strength together and used their remaining vital energies to conjure Mo Tenyun's image. The saint's fruit is a sacred item of the humans. It can be taken by any human, but it can never end up with outsiders, the five old men said in unison. Afterward, Mo Tenyun extended his hand and expanded to be 3,000 meters long. He grabbed at Kang Gian, and as the hand fell, it actually froze the space there, preventing Kang Gian from running away. He ended up being trapped by the giant hand. Booms constantly rang from the giant hand. Kang Gian was currently attacking with everything he had in attempt to break through the hand. The five old men trembled violently. They became extremely pale. The secret technique was supported by their vital energies, so it was equivalent to siphoning away their lives. It had already been very difficult for the five of them to cast the secret technique a second time in their current conditions, so they had literally put their lives on the line. They could not last for very long. Do it. At the same time, the great elders of the Qingyang clan secretly communicated with each other. They formed seals with their hands at the same time and used an ancient secret technique, borrowing from the forces of the world. Locus reversal. They called out at the same time. Suddenly, they disappeared, having moved to another location through the ancient secret technique. They had switched positions with the rock beside Jian Chen, arriving by his side instantaneously. Don't resist. Relax. Qing Yang Zhu Zhao spoke in a stern voice. They formed hand seals again and used the locus reversal a second time. This time, they traveled several dozen kilometers, appearing in a region of empty land with Jian Chen. The people of the Qingyang clan had escaped with the saint's fruit. The other humans all reacted by crying out. They quickly pursued. Qingyang Qingyun glanced past the people pursuing them and heavily said, "The space here is unstable, so it's very difficult to create a space gate. Let's go." The other great elders did not hesitate at all, immediately leaving the area as quickly as possible with Jian Chen. God damn it, how did it end up like this? Kaiser and the Tiger Emperor could not help but swear. They were extremely irritated. Originally, they had thought everything would be flawless, but never did they think that Kang Qian would end up trapped, allowing Jian Chen to flee with the saint's fruit. Little Phoenix, you're much stronger than before but still not enough to injure me. I have matters to attend to today, so I'll fight with you some other day, Kaiser growled. He wanted to go chase Jian Chen. However, Hong Lian immediately sent the scorching godfire hairpin at Kaiser with terrifying white flames, forcing him to face it seriously. He had no time to chase Jian Chen. Before we decide victory today, you won't be leaving, Hong Lian coldly said. Her attacks became more intense before pinning Kaiser down. Hai Yu was the same, using everything he had to keep the Tiger Emperor busy and prevent him from leaving. Although the Path Lord and Ruijin fought an intense battle in outer space, they always paid attention to what was happening below. Seeing how Jian Chen had actually fled with the saint's fruit, the Path Lord immediately panicked. He no longer bothered with Ruijin, wanting to pursue Jian Chen. Human Saint Emperor, our battle is still not over. With a golden flash of light, Ruijin slashed across the top of the Path Lord's head while he was distracted. He cut through some hair, Almost injuring the Path Lord was flustered and exasperated. His face was pale white. He had said the same thing to Ruijin just before. He did not think that the same line would be thrown back to him so quickly. Chapter 1166. Returning to the Protector Clan. 1. Jian Chen was carried along by the great elders of the Qingyang clan, flying into the distance as quickly as they could. The great elders had all reached Saint King many years ago, so their grasp over space was much more powerful than Jian Chen's. At full speed, they were much faster than Jian Chen even when he used the illusory flash. At this moment, all of them were stern. They only bothered to travel toward a faraway region of space that was stable. They knew that they had basically become everyone's enemy by taking Jian Chen away like this. They were great elders of a protector clan and possessed exalted statuses, but no one worried about their identities when the Saint's Fruit was on the line. There were no Saint Kings that could resist the temptation of reaching Saint Emperor. As long as they became Saint Emperors, they had no need to fear the protector clans, so they obviously had no need to be afraid of offending them. A large group of human experts pursued from close behind. The people who knew the effects of the Saint's Fruit were affected in particular, having become green with greed. Some of them used secret techniques to travel faster, so they rapidly drew closer to Jian Chen and the others. Hong Lian, Hai Yu, and Ruijin all kept a Saint Emperor busy each. They prevented the Saint Emperors from interfering with Jian Chen's escape, and they were in no shape to consider anything else. Borrowing from the forces of the world, locus reversal. The great elders of the Qingyang clan used the secret technique again and traversed over 100 kilometers. Afterward, they continued to flee with Jian Chen. It was very taxing to use the secret technique, let alone the fact that they had to bring an additional person along. As a result, they could not use it continuously even with their strength, requiring a time to buffer. The two parties, where one ran and the other pursued, traveled for 1,000 kilometers before finally arriving in a region of space that was relatively more stable. Qingyang King Yun immediately constructed a space gate. At the same time, over 10 balls of surging energy and sword chi shot over from behind with lightning-like speed. Every single attack possessed devastating power. They were all attacks from Saint Kings at great perfection, some from protector clans and others from ancient clans or independent cultivators. The violent attacks surged toward the space gate with unstoppable forces. Wherever they passed, the space would violently shake, as if it were about to shatter. The affected space impacted Qingyang King Yun while he was creating a space gate as well, because the space there became rather unstable. Go quick, Qingyang King Yun growled. His voice was filled with worry. All the great elders became extremely stern. Without any hesitation, they entered the space gate with Jian Chen as fast as they could. The space gate disappeared instantly after they had all entered it. The space there had also returned to how it was, and soon afterward, all the attacks landed on that region of space. It caused the space there to shatter and the surrounding radius of several thousand meters to violently tremble. Damn it, those bastards from the Qingyang clan. We actually let them get away. I never thought that the Saint's Fruit would end up with the Qingyang clan in the end. Looks like another Saint Emperor will appear on our Tianyu on continent soon. It's just a pity that he's not a member of our clan, but the Qingyang clan's. Sigh. It only appears after 40,000 years, something many of our ancestors have missed purely because of luck. I've missed it just like this. What a pity. What a pity. It's all because of those three vagrant magical beasts that don't belong to the Beast God continent. If they didn't do everything they did to protect Jian Chen, how would the fruit have ended up with the Qingyang clan? Now they've done it. Not only do they have an unprecedented prodigy, they have an exceptional relationship with the Winged Tiger God. Coupled with a Saint Emperor in the future, is there still anyone on the Tianyu on continent that can stop them? All the experts broke into discussion. Regret and dejection crossed the faces of many, while the experts from the protector clans appeared worried as well. The Qingyang clan was now far more powerful than what they could imagine. None of them wished for a protector clan to be more powerful than themselves. Boom, boom, boom. Several violent sounds rang out as violent energy splattered in all directions. The space shook heavily after being struck, while the supreme presence of Saint Emperors filled the surroundings. It was enough to cause the ground to shake from the presences alone. Qingyang stood proudly in the sky as he radiated with a supreme presence. He stood like he was a king looking down on his people. He had broken out of the secret technique from the five old men of Mercenary City with his supreme strength. His tremendous presence had directly crushed and collapsed Mo Danyun's figure. The five old men violently jerked and a mouthful of blood shot out at the same time. The blood scattered into the air as mist, and they instantly became extremely pale. They were all haggard, and the light in the eyes of four of them quickly vanished, becoming dull. They collapsed to the ground. Only one of them managed to stay standing with much difficulty. The last old man stared fixedly at Qingyang, who had broken free. He powerlessly said, "It's a pity that the five of us have already reached the end of our lives. Otherwise. Before he could finish speaking, the light in his eyes faded rapidly as well. He had departed the world full of unwillingness and regret. Tian Jian and the elders of Mercenary City stood silently from afar as they looked at the five ice-cold corpses of the old men. All of their faces had darkened in sorrow. They did not stop the five old men because they knew they did not have much time left. Even if they did not die here today, they would pass away in meditation in Mercenary City. The death of the five veterans has allowed the Tianyu on continent to keep the saints' fruit. They laid down their lives for a noble cause. They died spectacularly in battle and did not pass away silently in Mercenary City," Tian Jian heavily said. Qingyang slowly withdrew his supreme presence. He looked around nonchalantly and said, "The saints' fruit has already been taken away, and its whereabouts are unknown. It's about time I returned." Although he had spoken very ordinarily, his voice echoed through the surroundings, allowing everyone to hear it clearly. "No, Qingyang, we must obtain the saints' fruit. You are the fastest in the world. You should be able to catch them." Lanky Rose refused to give up. However, before he could finish speaking, Qingyang had already shot off into the distance as a faint blur. He seemed to have fused with space completely, moving through it silently. His speed was unbelievable, disappearing in an instant. To no surprise, he headed to the Beast God continent. "Qingyang!" The Tiger Emperor angrily roared. He was extremely unwilling to give up, and even Kaiser's complexion became extremely dark. "Let's go." Kaiser ordered a retreat as he ground his teeth. He immediately abandoned his opponent with Lanky Rose and left. This time, Hong Lian and Hai Yu did not stick to them desperately. They allowed him to leave, before heading to Ruijin together. The Path Lord raised an eyebrow and said, "Golden Divine Dragon, our battle ends here. Farewell." With that, he was about to leave. "Leaving won't be that easy," Ruijin icily exclaimed. His killing intent was sharp as his sword shone brightly with golden light. He clung onto the Path Lord tightly. "Scorching Purgatory!" Hong Lian cried out from afar. She had already arrived, and the large swaths of white flames had already surged from the Scorching God Fire Hairpin, filling the region of outer space. It formed a huge fireball, enveloping both Ruijin and the Path Lord. The terrifying temperature caused the space there to violently ripple. Even with the Path Lord's grasp over the mysteries of the world, which were far more profound than any Saint King's understanding, he was unable to use any spatial abilities to flee. Afterward, the hairpin flew into the fireball and shot toward the Path Lord. At the same time, Haiyu rushed in with his origin energy armor as well. He shot a blade of light from his machete toward the Path Lord. Chapter 1167, Returning to the Protector Clan, 2. The Path Lord of Carnal Desire's expression suddenly changed. He was still injured, having not yet recovered from the wounds caused by the barrier spirits of Mercenary City. He could temporarily protect himself as he fought against Ruijin in this current state, but he had no confidence in being able to retreat when faced with attacks from all three of them. What pained him the most was the fact that all three of them were protected by Origin Energy armor. It was very difficult for him to harm them with his power as a Saint Emperor, while his Fame techniques were ineffective due to the pearl that protected the soul. Their weapons also contained Origin Energy, something that only those beyond Saint Emperor could control. It was energy that belonged to a whole different domain, so even Saint Emperors found it difficult to withstand injuries caused by Origin Energy. The Path Lord became extremely grim. He collected the surrounding energy of the world with his abilities as a Saint Emperor and struck at the three of them with three palm strikes. Each strike was filled with extremely violent power, and they even contained a Saint Emperor's mysteries of the world. Even Saint Kings at great perfection would become as weak as ants before this great power. It was not something they could withstand at all. Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Haiyu showed no fear as they aggressively attacked the Path Lord. Before their Origin Energy weapons, the attacks were nothing. They collapsed the palm strikes using their weapons before continuing without slowing down, striking at the Path Lord with their Origin Energy weapons as they emitted a bright light. The three of them utterly hated the Path Lord, so they used everything they had. The Origin Energy weapons were swung as they stood in a triangle, where their vast presences caused space to freeze up. They locked tightly onto the Path Lord's presence. The Path Lord struggled to remain as composed as before. He suddenly roared, "Do you really think that I'm easy to be trifled with?" A vast and surging storm of energy erupted from his body, forming a whirlwind of energy that wreaked havoc in all directions. It caused space to shake and crack open everywhere. Extremely pure and powerful energy had condensed in both his hands. He avoided the furious Ruijin and Hong Lian, charging toward Haiyu on of his own accord. One of his hands seemed to have fused with the surrounding space, sweeping through the air with a string of illusionary afterimages. It seemed slow, yet it struck Haiyu's machete extremely swiftly. His hand did not come in contact with the machete, but the energy in his hand slammed into the side of the blade. It knocked the machete out of Haiyu's hand and caused Haiyu's arm to become numb. The Path Lord's other hand also struck Haiyu's chest with lightning-like speed after knocking away the blade. The energy in his hand erupted, blowing Haiyu far away. Haiyu's armor flickered in color, blocking the force behind the palm strike. The Path Lord immediately charged through the opened. He knew that it was very difficult for him to injure the three of them, so there would be no benefits to gain if he continued fighting while heavily injured. At this moment, a terrifying wave of heat swept over from behind. The scorching god fire hairpin had shot over extremely quickly. It had basically reached the Path Lord's back already. The Path Lord had already run out of time to dodge. He turned around and hurriedly launched an attack with his hand, using the energy in the surroundings to block the attack. However, the Path Lord's palm strike was hurried. It lacked power, so the hairpin flew through it like a knife through hot butter, flying for the Path Lord's face. The Path Lord's eyes narrowed, and with a wave of his hand, a divine hall immediately flew out from his space ring. It became the size of a house in an instant, standing before him. The hairpin struck the divine hall and erupted with a deafening boom. The entire divine hall shook violently as cracks quickly expanded across it. At this moment, a resplendent golden light suddenly flashed behind the Path Lord's back. Ruijin had appeared behind him at a certain moment. He gripped the sword with his right hand as he maintained a seal with his left. The sword stabbed toward the Path Lord as a streak of light. The Path Lord was shocked when he sensed what was happening behind him. Ruijin had appeared too suddenly, and even he had failed to sense his movement. He praised inside, "The various abilities and secret techniques of the Dragon Clan really are profound." Even as he thought that, he responded very quickly. He ignored the rippling space and instantly fused with his surroundings with his abilities as a Saint Emperor. He wanted to dodge Ruijin's attack. Secret technique of the Dragon Clan, pin down space. At that crucial moment, Ruijin's left hand suddenly pressed against the space there and instantly froze it, becoming as tough as rock. Caught off guard, the Path Lord was also affected. He froze up, having been pinned down. But the next moment, the Path Lord broke through the frozen space with his great strength. He had forcefully broken through Ruijin's secret technique, but it cost him a moment. He had lost the best opportunity to dodge, so Ruijin's sword impaled him mercilessly and appeared from his back. The Path Lord produced a deep grunt. Being impaled by a sword with origin energy in the chest was definitely a horrible feeling. It was much worse than normal injuries. Bang! The Path Lord kicked back and landed a foot on Ruijin's chest accurately. It knocked him far away, and the sword was drawn out as well. The Path Lord's white robes had already become dyed red with blood. His face was even paler now, and his injuries were even worse than before. "Die, human Saint Emperor!" Hong Lian shouted. Flames surged around her as she made her way around the Divine Hall. She continued to attack the Path Lord with her hairpin in her hand as she stared at him with icy cold killing intent. The Path Lord rapidly retreated. He glanced past the three of them coldly and gritted his teeth. "If I had recovered from my injuries that the barrier spirit of Mercenary City gave me, just the three of you would not be enough to injure me. However, you three are still not enough to stop me from leaving." The Path Lord backpedaled and no longer faced the three of them head-on. His two hands slowly circled around with extremely profound truths of the world. They seemed to have created some connection with the region of space as the two resonated together. "Void Shatter!" Suddenly, the Path Lord yelled out. Immediately, extremely powerful world force shook as the space in front of him shattered. It rapidly collapsed, becoming an eternal darkness. There was only void inside. Hong Lian's face changed slightly. She knew that the Path Lord could shatter and collapse space with his Saint Emperor abilities. Entering it would mean almost certain doom, so she immediately stayed far away from it. Chapter 1168, Returning to the Protector Clan. 3. The shattered space collapsed piece by piece while the affected area expanded. From afar, it looked like a huge black hole, preventing Ruijin, Hong Lian, and Hai Yu from getting anywhere close. They avoided it from afar. The Path Lord of Carnal Desires vanished behind the collapsed space while their visibility of his was obstructed. A while later, the space began to recover slowly and finally closed up completely, but the Path Lord was nowhere to be seen. "We actually let him escape," Hong Lian said, exasperated. "Saint Emperors know quite a few abilities. Facing Saint Emperors with our strength is obviously not a question, but killing them will possess a certain difficulty. Though, the human Saint Emperor has suffered a strike from me. My sword impaled his chest, and he won't be able to make a full recovery from that injury in a short amount of time." "We failed to kill him, but we made him pay a price," Ruijin said. His voice was also filled with some regret. "We better go find Jian Chen now. He is left with the people of the Protector Clans. He might be a part of them, but any connections of family or friends will become insignificant. I'm worried he'll come in danger. He's our only hope to return to our clansmen, so we can't let any accidents happen to him. Also, Haiyu's situation is getting worse. He needs to be healed with the origin energy of Radiant Saint Force," Hong Lian sternly explained the situation. Ruijin nodded. He immediately left with Hong Lian and Haiyu, constantly casting secret techniques to search for Jian Chen's whereabouts. With their departures, the remaining scattered group of Saint Kings in the air sighed before leaving as well. Many of them were filled with envy, regret, and an unwillingness to give up. Many of them had anticipated a day that they would become a Saint Emperor for a very long time, a position where they would stand at the apex and surpass the Protector Clans. Now that they had just narrowly missed the Saint's Fruit, they found it difficult to accept the arousal of hope and then utter despair. This was because there were not one Saint King who was not interested in the realm of Saint Emperors. Once a Saint King reached Saint Emperor, not only would it gift them with supreme power, their lives would be extended by several thousand years. The region outside the Death Nest became much quieter. Most of the Saint Kings had already left, and only a small number remained. They were unwilling to leave. When Jian Chen and the Great Elders emerged from the Space Gate, they were no longer in the original space. They had entered an independent space that had been split open. It was teeming with the energy of the world and the scenery was charming. It was a beautiful miniature world. Jian Chen glanced around as a gleam of light flashed through his eyes. He had been here before, so he recognized the place with a single glance. It was the space inhabited by the Protector Qingyang clan. Qingyang Qingyun had brought them back to the Protector clan. The space was independent of the outside world, and the world gate would be tightly closed under ordinary circumstances, isolating it completely. People could only leave through a special method. Now that he was here, Jian Chen did not feel safe at all. Instead, he felt a great sense of danger, far greater than when he had been encircled by the Saint Emperor vengeful spirits. Jian Chen's heart sank, but he showed none of that on his face. He glanced at the authoritative great elders around him secretly and discovered that they were all feeling joy and excitement from the bottom of their hearts. Jian Chen could even see burning desire and impatience in Qingyang Qingyun's eyes. At this moment, Qingyang Qingyun looked toward Jian Chen. Just when he wanted to speak, Jian Chen cut him off. "Great elders, I'm very heavily injured, so I need to find a place to heal immediately. Otherwise, it might leave behind injuries." Jian Chen was currently bathed in blood with nothing else to be seen. Vicious gashes littered his body all over. The gashes were bone deep and ghastly. Without his chaotic body's toughness, someone else in a similar condition as him would probably have collapsed long ago. "Xiangshen, your wounds are just far too heavy. Come with us to the ancestral hall to heal first. There are medicines there that can help you recover quickly," Qingyang Zhuyangxiao said in concern. "I thank you for your concern, but I have medicine on me. I can deal with my wounds myself." With that, Jian Chen's face changed and blood spurted from his mouth. He weakly said, "My condition is rapidly worsening. I can't delay it any longer. I need to find a place immediately so I can go into seclusion and recover." With that, Jian Chen flew to a nearby mountain peak in a teetering fashion. He used the Emperor armament to carve out a cave and disappeared into it. Qingyang Qingyun stared deeply at Jian Chen's back as he moved away. A gleam of light flickered through his eyes, and he became uneasy. However, he recovered very quickly and laughed aloud. "I never thought that the Saint's Fruit would be obtained by our clan. This holds far too much importance for the clan. A Saint Emperor will appear in our Qingyang clan soon." "Yeah, once Xiangshen consumes the Saint's Fruit, he'll definitely reach Saint Emperor successfully with his talent," Qingyang Zhuyangxiao faintly smiled. An indescribable pride was plastered on his face and he glanced at Qingyang Qingyun, perhaps out of pure coincidence. With that, Qingyang Qingyun's face hardened, but it only lasted for a slight moment. He recovered in the blink of an eye and smiled faintly as well. "You're right. Xiangshen's talent is unprecedented. He's achieved such great things in less than 100 years. I believe Xiangshen will break through to Saint Emperor very quickly and become a supreme expert that can shake the world." "All right, let's end the conversation here. We've all expended a lot of energy on our trip to the Death Nest, so we better go recover quick. We need to maintain our peak conditions to repel any sneak attacks from other experts. After all, the Saint's Fruit holds far too much temptation. We need to be on guard at all times." The great elders all left together and headed to the central divine hall. Jian Chen stood within the cave with a rather dark expression. Through his presence, he had caught every single detail of the great elders' conversation and their changes in expression. He knew exactly how they had reacted. "This place is indeed not safe. Qingyang Qingyun's greed for the Saint's Fruit is far too strong. The other great elders may not have shown it before, but who knows what they're thinking," Jian Chen thought. He had suddenly found that all the people of the Qingyang clan were no longer reliable at that moment, including Qingyang Zhuzhou and Qingyang Zhuyangxiao. This was because the Saint's Fruit was just far too enticing. As the only shortcut to Saint Emperor, any connections, like kinship or friendship, were as fragile as rice paper. Chapter 1169, Amidst Danger. "Making a full recovery as soon as possible is the most urgent matter. I need to return to my peak condition in the shortest amount of time. Only then can I deal with the dangers that come later. It's a pity that Ruijin and the other two aren't here. Or even if the great elders really were scheming to take the Saint's Fruit, There's no need for me to fear so much. My strength is far from enough to contending with them, sadly. Jian Chen thought inside. He set up a barrier at the entrance of the cave and entered the saint artifact to heal. In the blink of an eye, 2 days passed. Everything had been peaceful in the Qingyang clan during that time. The seven great elders all stayed in the central divine hall to recover the saint force they used in the death nest. Jian Chen stayed in the artifact space for 2 days as well. He had recovered long ago with the artifact spirit's healing and was currently adjusting himself to peak condition. I can't go outside right now. If I do, it's extremely possible that they'll ask to take the fruit from me. If I don't hand it over, there'll be conflict. I still don't have the ability to hold on to the fruit with my strength. It's best if I sit here and drag it out. I hope Ruijin and the others can make it in time. I won't have to fear the Qingyang clan by then. Jian Chen planned inside. He was currently in the independent space of the Qingyang clan, which could be described as the safest place possible as well as the most dangerous place possible. The place had existed for an extremely long time and possessed a wondrously powerful emperor armament. Even his divine hall and saint artifact would be useless once the emperor armament was used. The 30-meter tall wave-breaking blade stood upright in the forbidden grounds of the Tyrant's Blade School. It hovered a meter above the ground as it glowed with a hazy light. The light consisted of no ordinary glow. They were blades of light that possessed great power. An extremely domineering presence was vaguely coiled around the blade. Gai Haiyudai sat atop the blade's hilt in simple robes. His entire body was surrounded by the terrifying light of the blade, but it did not harm him at all. It looked like he was being protected by the blade. A powerful and pure energy constantly surged out of the blade before being absorbed by Gai Haiyudao like a whale taking in water. His body seemed to be a bottomless pit, where no matter how much energy entered his body, it would be impossible to fill. All the energy disappeared like a rock thrown into the sea. The emperor armament of protector clans had already been established as forbidden weapons. They could not be used in ordinary times since their power were just far too great. Several saint kings working together was required just to gain rough control over one, and they would suffer from a backlash afterward, heavily injuring those saint kings. This was why the emperor armaments were terrifying. There had never been a person throughout history who cultivated by absorbing the energy of the emperor armament. Even in the glorious age of saint emperors, no one dared to do that. There was only Gai Haiyudao. As the emperor armament's energy was rapidly consumed, Gai Haiyudao's presence basically increased with every moment of time. The speed was astounding. His strength increased rapidly. He had no need to comprehend the mysteries of the world since recovering his memories was equivalent to recovering his former cultivation level. A few figures flew over from afar before kneeling down courteously outside the forbidden grounds. They were the great elders of the Tyrant's Blade sect, and they were all gloomy and dejected. Founding ancestor, we've returned. We were useless and unable to retrieve the saint's fruit, an old man said, depressed. He felt extremely regretful. Gai Haiyudao slowly opened his eyes. His gaze was extremely ordinary, but within hid an extremely sharp light, like a blade. It was acute and forceful. His gazed in the direction of the death nest, as if he could see the distant place through space. That's not a problem. The saint's fruit isn't that important. It can let people reach Saint Emperor, but you still can break through without it, Gai Haiyudao said in an extremely simple tone. But ancestor, reaching Saint Emperor has become extremely difficult. Saint Emperors have stopped appearing in the 10 protector clans. We only have one human Saint Emperor now, and he became one by paving his own path of cultivation with his willpower, a great elder bitterly replied. Gai Haiyudao glanced over all of them. All of the great elders shivered inside when their founding ancestors' gaze passed by them. They all felt like that had been locked onto by an extremely sharp blade. They had actually felt dread at the bottom of their hearts. The great elders were extremely shocked as their hearts churned. They also felt even more admiration for Gai Haiyudao as well as more fear. They knew their founding ancestors' true strength was much greater than the realm of Saint King he had recently reached. I can let you become Saint Emperors at most in 100 years and at least a few decades. You can all wait until that day, Guy Haiyudao simply replied. However, the great elders felt like they had been struck by a bolt from the blue when they heard what he said. They became filled with disbelief. Founding ancestor, all of you are dismissed. In the next few years, properly consolidate your foundations. Guy Haiyudao cut off the great elder. Yes, ancestor. Even though the great elders were doubtful, they dared not disobey Guy Haiyudao's orders. They all left courteously. After they had left, Guy Haiyudao focused his attention on the direction of the death nest again. He mumbled, "Just what does Mo Tanyan want to do? He has gone to great lengths to create the death nest. I must say it's earned my admiration. After a million years of reincarnations, my wounds from the laws have finally been erased. I've understood a lot after so many reincarnations and so many lives. I have a lot benefited. So once I fully recover my strength, I'll definitely be able to reach another level. I just wonder when the nine of them are going to awaken." Chapter 1170, Ill Motives. Jian Chen remained in the artifact space. Right now, the Qingyang clan was no longer a safe place. It was extremely dangerous. Staying in it had suddenly become like a prison. He did not possess the secret technique to open the closed world gate. The Qingyang clan was exceptionally quiet today. Many clansmen sealed themselves in quiet rooms to devote themselves to cultivation. The dense energy of the world quickly surged toward a few mountains peaks or a few residences. From afar, there were only a few younger people scattered about as they practiced martial arts and a few people hiding in desolate places, casting battle skills against tough rock faces. An old but upright figure suddenly emerged from the central divine hall. His presence was erased, so he seemed simple, just like any old man. He was one of the seven great elders, Qingyang Qingyun. Qingyang Qingyun had appeared silently by the door. His profound eyes twinkled slightly. He first looked around before turning his attention to the mountain peak where Jian Chen had gone into seclusion. After hesitating slightly, a determined light flickered through his eyes and he moved. He flew toward the cave with extremely great speed while remaining silent. He arrived outside the cave in the blink of an eye. He calmly gazed at the barrier Jian Chen had cast down at the entrance before smiling as if he had just seen a joke. With a rapid movement of his hands, he used hand seals to cast a secret technique. He managed to pass through the barrier through a technique that looked like teleportation and entered the cave without triggering the barrier. After all, Jian Chen's comprehension of the mysteries of the world remained at the level of sane rulers. The barrier was basically non-existent before Qingyang Qingyun, who was at the great perfection of Saint King and knew many secret techniques. In the slightly dim cave, the fist-sized saint artifact hovered in the air and was alit with a faint, golden light. It illuminated the cave to its dim state. Qingyang Qingyun arrived before it and stood with his arms behind his back. He stared at it in interest and frowned slightly. He murmured to himself, "I didn't think that little bastard would be so clever to hide in this small tower to recover. This basically removes any possibility of me getting the saint's fruit from him." Qingyang Qingyun was rather unwilling to stop there. He paced around the saint artifact as his face gradually darkened. He murmured, "This tower is extremely tough. Only saint emperors can smash through it. I can't do anything to him if he hides in there. So what should I do?" Jian Chen currently sat in a hall in the center of the artifact space. His expression was extremely ugly. The saint artifact had already accepted him as a master, so an extremely obscure connection had already developed between him and the saint artifact. He understood the situation outside extremely well through the help of the artifact spirit even though he was inside. Jian Chen had begun paying attention to Qingyang Qingyun's every movement the moment he had entered the cave. "Hmph, I never thought that Qingyang Qingyun would be so flustered and that he would come to find me so quickly. I just wonder how many people are preoccupied by the saint's fruit." Jian Chen coldly wondered as his gaze became icy. If he had not hid in the artifact space beforehand, he probably would have fallen to Qingyang Qingyun's vicious means. Qingyang Qingyun paced around outside for a while before finally gritting his teeth. He coldly said, "Since that damn brat's in the tower, I might as well just take the tower away. I can slowly come up with a method to open it in the future." Just as Qingyang Qingyun wanted to take the saint artifact away, His expression suddenly changed. He glanced outside before arriving near a cave wall in a flash. He silently disappeared into the rock. Soon afterward, Qing Yanqing Jewelry arrived as well. He passed through the barrier with a secret technique just like Qing Yanqing Yun. He paced around the saint artifact for quite a while before his expression changed in the end. He sensed the arrival of someone, so he immediately used a secret technique to hide in the mountain. The third person was Qing Yanyu on Zhenghua. He knew quite a few secret techniques as well, so Jian Chen's barrier was useless against him. Seeing the floating saint artifact, he also frowned slightly. However, two powerful presences appeared outside at this moment. Qing Yangzu Yangxiao and Qing Yangzu Zhao had come at the same time, flying to where Jian Chen was resting. However, they differed from the previous three by not concealing themselves. They flew over boldly, causing many members of the clan to raise their heads as admiration filled their faces. Qing Yanyu on Zhenghua was surprised. He could not leave the cave in time, so with no further choice, he did the same as Qing Yanqing Yun and Qing Yanqing Jewelry. He used a secret technique to fuse into the surrounding rocks and completely erased his presence. Qing Yangzu Zhao and Qing Yangzu Yangxiao arrived outside the cave together. They hovered 10 meters away from the entrance and stared into it. However, they did not set foot into it. Looks like Xiangshan's still healing. I wonder when he'll make a full recovery, Qing Yangzu Zhao said with an ordinary tone. Xiangshan's a class 7 Radiant Saint Master as well. He can control powerful Radiant Saint Force, so although his wounds are very heavy, I believe he can heal them very quickly. Great Grandfather, why don't you go rest in the Ancestral Hall first? I'll stay here and wait for Xiangshan to come out, said Qing Yangzu Yangxiao. Qing Yangzu Zhao hesitated slightly before nodding. All right, Yangxiao, you stay here. I'll go back to the Ancestral Hall first. Qing Yangzu Zhao turned around and left while Qing Yangzu Yangxiao stayed behind. He found a flat area to sit down. The barrier that Jian Chen had cast down stood 3 meters in front of him. Jian Chen murmured in the artifact space, "Of the 7 Great Elders, 3 have already tried to do something to me while I was recovering. But it's fortunate that Qing Yangzu Yangxiao and Qing Yangzu Zhao arrived in time, or the saint artifact might have been taken away by the three of them." Now that Qing Yangzu Yangxiao is personally watching over outside, the people in the cave won't dare to do anything. Did he do this because he knew the three of them had already entered the cave and had come to prevent them? Or is it purely a coincidence? I still can't trust any of them. Jian Chen lowered his head in thought before moving. He had already silently vanished from the artifact space, reappearing in the dim cave. Now that he could no longer stay here, since it would be very easy for him to fall prey to the schemes of others, he might as well appear in front of them in a bold fashion. Perhaps he could stop them from acting out in the open, in hopes that they wouldn't lay their hands on him so easily. Jian Chen put the saint artifact away and made his way outside as if nothing had happened at all. He discovered Qing Yangzu Yangxiao sitting outside and a sliver of surprise immediately flashed across his face. He asked, "Great Grandfather, why are you here? Have you come looking for me because of some urgent matter?" Qing Yangzu Yangxiao stood up and examined Jian Chen up and down. He smiled, "Xiangshan, looks like you've fully recovered from your wounds. Come with me. I just happen to have some matters I want to discuss with you." Jian Chen nodded before following Qing Yangzu Yangxiao toward the floating piece of land. However, they approached the Divine Hall at the center, Jian Chen stopped. He said, "Great Grandfather, the scenery in the garden over there is quite nice. Why don't we go discuss there?" With that, Jian Chen flew to the nearby garden without waiting for Qing Yangzu Yangxiao to agree. Looking at Jian Chen's back, Qing Yangzu Yangxiao did not show any displeasure at all. Instead, he smiled slightly and softly murmured, "This kid's rather cautious." Afterward, he flew over as well. Soon after that, Qing Yangzu Zhao, Qing Yanyu on Wuji, and Qing Yangqing Yun emerged from the central divine hall as well and gathered within the garden's pavilion. "Haha, Xiangshan's done it wonderfully this time. You've actually succeeded in obtaining the saint's fruit in front of so many experts and brought it back to the clan in perfect condition." "Exactly. Xiangshan's actions this time were far too outstanding. obtaining the priceless Saint's Fruit for our Qingyang clan. Now that we have the fruit, our clan's strength will definitely skyrocket. Without much time, a Saint Emperor will be born in our clan. Xiangshan's committed a tremendous contribution. Wrong. It won't be one Saint Emperor, but two. We've all witnessed Xiangshan's talent. I believe in less than 100 years, Xiangshan will reach Saint Emperor. Qingyang Yuan Wuji and Qingyang Qingyun showered Jian Chen with praises as soon as they arrived. They constantly commended Jian Chen. Qingyang Zhu Yangxiao and Qingyang Zhu Zhao silently sat on the stone seats. Their faces were expressionless, so it was impossible to tell what they were feeling. Jian Chen's complexion became rather ugly. The meaning behind Qingyang Yuan Wuji and Qingyang Qingyun's words was that the fruit was not Jian Chen's but the clan's. Why haven't Qingyun, Juari, and Zhenghua come yet? I've just contacted them, Qingyang Qingyun suddenly asked. Qingyang Qingyun, Qingyang King Juari, and Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua appeared at the doorstep of the Central Divine Hall as soon as he said that before heading over in unison. All 7 great elders of the Qingyang clan had gathered at that moment. Chapter 1171, Internal Strife of the Qingyang Clan. 1. The great elders all sat in order on the stone seats within the pavilion. Many of them faintly smiled with joy they could not hide. Only Jian Chen was in a very bad mood because he knew what they were going to talk about next would definitely be related to the Saint's Fruit. Qingyang Qingyun looked around and gently cleared his throat. He said, "Since everyone is here, let's cut to the chase. I believe everyone already knows what we are going to discuss, so let's get straight to it. How do you feel that we should split the Saint's Fruit? Basically, all the experts on the continent know that we, the Qingyang clan, have obtained the Saint's Fruit. In order to prevent a few experts from attacking our clan, since the temptation is too great, we need to use the fruit as soon as possible. Otherwise, won't our losses be severe if it was taken away by someone else?" Qingyang Qingyun righteously spoke. "That's right, and the appearance of the fruit this time has even led to the collaboration of the Path Lord of Carnal Desires and the 3 Saint Emperors of the Beast God Continent. If the 4 of them attack our clan, regardless of the consequences they would face, in an attempt to obtain the fruit, we would end up in deep trouble," said Qingyang Yuan Wuji. He was grim. "But there's 7 of us and only 1 fruit. How should we split it?" Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua asked while deep in thought as the light in his eyes flickered. "Who else can we give it to? Is there another Saint King at great perfection in our clan other than Qingyun?" "In my opinion, the Saint's Fruit should obviously go to Qingyun. Only by giving it to him can we use the fruit to its greatest capacity," Qingyang Qingyun clearly stated. "Qingyun has reached great perfection many years ago, and he only lacks a final step before he can reach Saint Emperor. Using the fruit on him is a waste," Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua nonchalantly replied. Qingyang Qingyun's face changed slightly. Before he could say anything, Qingyang Qingyun suddenly stood up and slammed the stone table before him. Although it was extremely tough, the sculpted table was reduced to dust. He angrily said, "Zhenghua, what are you trying to say? Are you saying that Qingyun is incompetent?" Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua smiled slightly. "Please don't get mad, Brother Yun. Qingyun is the only Saint King at great perfection out of all of us, as well as the most powerful member of our clan. I just feel that if we use the fruit on him, we won't be able to use the fruit to its greatest potential. Do you have an even better idea?" Qingyang Qingyun asked with a sunken face. "Of course." Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua smiled confidently and said, "Brother Qingyun only lacks a fortuitous encounter before he can reach Saint Emperor. If we give the fruit to someone else and the worldly phenomena invoked by that individual when they become Saint Emperor is comprehended by Brother Qingyun, then reaching Saint Emperor obviously won't be a question. That way, wouldn't there be 2 Saint Emperors from a single fruit?" "You say that easily. If reaching Saint Emperor really was that easy, the 10 protector clans would not have run out of Saint Emperors." "Zhenghua, I feel like you just want the fruit for yourself," Qingyang King Juari coldly said as he rebuked Qingyang Yuan Zhenghua. The great elders argued intensely such that they all became flushed. All that was missing was for them to fight. None of them noticed Jian Chen's pale white face. "Everyone, Ching Yang Zhuyangxiao finally yelled. He calmly said, "All you think about is how the saint's fruit will be distributed. You haven't considered just who obtained the fruit at all. The fruit isn't any of ours. It belongs to Xiangshan." "Correct. Xiangshan's contributions in obtaining the fruit were crucial. That's an irrefutable truth. However, if we hadn't intervened in the end, how would he have broken free from the encirclement? And with Xiangshan's unprecedented talent, having attained such accomplishments in less than 100 years, his future is unlimited. If he uses a heavenly resource to become a saint emperor with his talent, it's not necessarily a good matter either. It's extremely possible that Xiangshan won't be able to advance any further after becoming a saint emperor through these means," said Qing Yangqing Jewelry. "Out of all of us, the person who has the most authority in distributing the fruit is Xiangshan. Xiangshan, why don't you say what you plan on doing?" Qing Yang Zhuzhou suggested. He too drooled over the saint's fruit inside. After all, it was something that could give birth to saint emperors. Jian Chen glanced over the seven of them and said, "Great elders, the arguments today have been so intense. Let's talk about the saint's fruit some other day, just in case we fall out with one another." "No, we can't leave the saint's fruit hanging around. We need to deal with it as soon as possible." "I worry about intruders," a great elder firmly responded. Jian Chen's heart sank. He knew that it was no longer possible to drag things out, so he made up his mind. "I'll be honest. When I obtained the fruit, I already had an owner in mind, and it's not me, nor any of you here." "Is it the three magical beasts?" "No, the saint's fruit is sacred to the humans. It cannot be consumed by magical beasts." Qing Yangqing Yun reacted violently. He suddenly stood up and glared at Jian Chen. "No, it's not them, but the Grand Elder of Mercenary City, Senior Tian Jian." "I've specifically fought for the fruit for Senior Tian Jian," Jian Chen replied. He no longer had any room for regret now. The garden fell silent. Everyone had become stunned by what Jian Chen had said. No one had ever thought that Jian Chen would actually leave the fruit to the Grand Elder of Mercenary City. "No, definitely not." A while later, someone abruptly yelled. Qing Yangqing Yun stared at Jian Chen. He was furious as he said, "The saint's fruit only appears once every 40,000 years. How can you give something as valuable as that to an outsider?" "Jian Chen, you must consider the clan first as a member of the clan. The fruit is just far too important to the clan. When I fought against the countless vengeful spirits, what did you do? What else did you do when Ruijin, Hong Lian, Hai Yu, and I fought through the encirclement of so many people? I've exchanged the fruit through bloodshed and risking my life, so it would belong to me. Who I decide to give the fruit to has nothing to do with you." Jian Chen also became very straightforward and forceful. He would definitely not hand over the saint's fruit. The faces of the great elders all darkened very much. Even Qing Yang Zhuzhou and Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao slightly frowned. They could accept it if the saint's fruit was used by any member of the clan, but if Jian Chen actually gave it to an outsider, that would be going too far. Jian Chen turned to Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao and said, "Great grandfather, please send me off. It looks like it is no longer suitable for me to stay in the protector clan." Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao hesitated before nodding. "Xiangshan, you are a member of the Zhu branch, and you are our branch's pride. No matter what happens, we will always stand by your side as long as you don't break the morals and harm the clansmen." With that, Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao began casting a secret technique, wanting to open the world gate for Jian Chen to leave. "Wait." Qing Yangqing Yun struck out with his palm, causing the surrounding space to violently shake. He disrupted what Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao was trying to do while he coldly stared at Jian Chen. He heavily said, "You can go, but you have to leave behind the saint's fruit. I don't care how much you put into obtaining the fruit, but as a member of the protector clan, you need to consider the clan with the utmost importance." "I will not be leaving behind the saint's fruit." Jian Chen's voice became icy as well. Fury began to burn inside of him. "Since you're not going to hand over the fruit, I'll come and get it myself." A sharp gleam of light flashed through Qing Yangqing Yun's eyes, and he arrived in front of Jian Chen in a flash. He grabbed at the space ring on Jian Chen's finger, wanting to take it, Jian Chen had been prepared long ago. The moment Qing Yang King Yun moved, the Emperor armament appeared in his right hand. Devastating chaotic force surged from the weapon as he swung it toward Qing Yang King Yun's hand with lightning-like speed. The strike was swift, precise, and vicious. It possessed all the power that Jian Chen had been secretly charging up. Qing Yang King Yun was surprised inside. He did not expect Jian Chen to react so quickly, but he was an experienced fighter himself as well. Tremendous amounts of Saint Force immediately gushed from his hand, and he shifted his movement, striking the face of the sword. Bang! With a muffled sound, the Emperor armament gently resonated. Jian Chen's attack had been nullified by Qing Yang King Yun. However, Jian Chen's attacks did not just stop there. With a twist of his wrist, the Emperor armament danced like a fan to redirect the remaining force before turning into a dark streak of light. It stabbed toward Qing Yang King Yun with unbelievable speed. Qing Yang King Yun remained calm. Extending a finger, a vast amount of world force shot out, colliding with the tip of the sword. With a boom, the pavilion in the garden was split into pieces. Violent ripples of energy shot out in all directions, turning the lovely garden into a mess. Jian Chen uncontrollably took three steps back, leaving behind three deep footprints. Qing Yang King Yun remained where he was, standing as firmly as a mountain. "Your strength is indeed rather spectacular outside, but it's quite not enough to fight with me," Qing Yang King Yun coldly said. Jian Chen tightly gripped the Emperor armament in his right hand. His presence became greater and greater. Although the disparity between their strength was very great, he was not scared. "Leave behind the Saint's Fruit and I'll let you leave," Qing Yang King Yun coldly commanded. He needed to obtain the Saint's Fruit. At this moment, many people flew over from afar. The commotion was just far too great, having alarmed them. Chapter 1172, Internal Strife of the Qing Yang Clan, 2. The great elders of the Yuan and Qing branches backed away in unison. They expressed their response and did not take part in the fight. At the same time, they used communication techniques to stop the clansmen hurrying over. "King Yun, you're an elder. Isn't it going a little too far by threatening a junior like this?" Qing Yang Zhu Zhao questioned in a heavy voice. He and Qing Yang Zhu Yang Xiao remained where they were and had not moved away. "You're all senior members of the clan, so you know the rules." He was looking for it himself. Qing Yang King Yun's face sank and his tone became icy as well. He had been at the great perfection of Saint King for many years now. Although he was only an inch away from Saint Emperor, he had not made any contact with the other realm of cultivation. He knew that it would be impossible for him to become a Saint Emperor in this life, so he needed to obtain the Saint's Fruit. "Of course we remember the rules of the clan well, but he's different than the other clansmen. He never grew up in the Protector Clan, and he's only joined recently from a side branch outside. His status now is a great elder as well, so you can't treat him like any old clansman. With his outstanding talent, I believe we can make some exceptions," Qing Yang Zhu Zhao. Qing Yang Zhu Yang Xiao walked over as well. He stood in front of Jian Chen and blocked Qing Yang King Yun. He said, "Most importantly, Xiang Shen only obtained this Saint's Fruit with the assistance of his three powerful friends. We, the Qing Yang clan, did not contribute much at all on the other hand, so I believe we have no right to take it away from him." Number. The rulers of the clan have never been broken in countless years. It doesn't matter how shocking Xiang Shen's talent is, he's still a member of the Qing Yang clan. He needs to follow the rules. Qing Yang King Yun did not give in at all as he spoke in a firm voice. Jian Chen also became angered with that. He deeply said, "If that's the case, I'll leave the clan from now on. In the future, the Protector Qing Yang clan has nothing to do with me." Qing Yang King Yun suddenly glared at Jian Chen. He heavily said, "The Qing Yang clan is one of the 10 protector clans of the continent. You can't just leave because you say you're leaving. Just with that, you've already broken the rules of the clan. I will capture you now and take you to the ancestral hall where the disciplinary elders will sentence you." With a flash, Qing Yang King Yun made his way around Qing Yang Zhu Yang Xiao. Energy surged from his right hand, materializing into a web-like net that shot toward Jian Chen. A sliver of anger also flashed through Qingying Zhuyangxiao's eyes. At that crucial moment, he threw a punch at Qingying Qingyun. Saint force surged within the fist, causing cracks to appear in the space that was much tougher than the outside world. Qingying Qingyun remained calm and composed. He gently struck out with his left hand and easily nullified the powerful saint force in Qingying Zhuyangxiao's hand. The net continued to toward Jian Chen. Jian Chen's presence became extremely powerful and battle intent surged from him. His glare became as sharp as a sword. He did not show any fear against a saint king at great perfection, quickly stabbing at Qingying Qingyun as a layer of chaotic force revolved around the emperor armament. Such overconfidence, Qingying Qingyun's lips curled in disdain. The net of energy split into two, a portion wrapped around the emperor armament while the other continued along the same trajectory toward Jian Chen. Jian Chen's emperor armament seemed like it had been tightly wrapped up now. Even the luster of the chaotic force was suppressed. Jian Chen did not become flustered. With a violent tremble of his hand, the emperor armament shook. Streaks of dark light broke free from Qingyang Qingyun's suppression and became brighter and brighter. The chaotic force on the emperor armament was rapidly breaking free from Qingyang Qingyun's restraints. At this moment, the other portion of the net had arrived over Jian Chen's head. Just as he was about to become entangled, a streak of golden light shot out from the center of his eyebrows. It became a 3-meter-tall golden tower, which hovered above his head and glimmered with the color of gold. The tip of the tower held back the net. The tower was tightly trapped by the net, but the emperor armament had finally broken free during this period of time. It glowed with a dark light as an aura of destruction radiated from it far and wide. It alerted many experts who were in seclusion, causing them to open their eyes and emerge. Swish! The sword cut through the air, and with its powerful and devastating might, it actually created a thin black crack in the reinforced space. It stabbed toward Qingyang Qingyun with almost unstoppable force. The speed of the sword was so great that it became invisible to the naked eye. All that could be seen was a flicker of darkness. The sword had arrived at Qingyang Qingyun's forehead with unbelievable speed. The forehead was the fatal weakness of any expert. It was where their meridian of life was located, so it was the place where their soul resided. Even saint kings at great perfection could suffer life-threatening injuries from the soul, and they could even die from it. Jian Chen's strike was aimed at Qingyang Qingyun's forehead. He had attacked to kill without showing any mercy at all. Qingyang Qingyun's face darkened. Chilling killing intent appeared in his eyes, and when the emperor armament was only 3 inches away from his forehead, the space around Jian Chen suddenly froze. He was locked in place in his posture of stabbing out with the sword. Even the emperor armament had come to a halt, forcefully stopped 3 inches away. However, this only lasted for a second. The frozen space was shattered by Jian Chen's chaotic force, but as soon as he regained his mobility, Qingyang Qingyun had already arrived by his side. He bellowed out, "You have committed an unforgivable crime, punishable by death, for trying to kill a great elder. As the highest ranking elder, I, Qingyang Qingyun, shall be representing the Qingyang clan to punish you." Qingyang Qingyun immediately sent a palm strike in Jian Chen's way. Energy surged from his palm and his attack seemed to have engulfed an entire region, causing the space around Jian Chen to become. Jian Chen was grim. His eyes were cold, and with a thought, the saint artifact immediately shrunk to the size of a fist and slipped out of the net. It flew over as a golden streak of light and stood in front of Jian Chen like a shield. A rumble immediately erupted when Qingyang Qingyun's attack landed on the saint artifact. The power hidden within was far beyond imagination. He blew the saint artifact away with the attack, and the golden tower smashed into Jian Chen, even forcing him to rapidly retreat. Powerful ripples of energy surged in all directions, reducing the garden to nothing. Almost all the exotic flowers and herbs had been reduced to dust. Chapter 1173, Internal Strife of the Qingyang Clan. 3. Jian Chen uncontrollably took over 10 steps back before finally nullifying the powerful force. Just as he stabilized himself, Ching Yang King Yun aggressively attacked with his second palm strike. He continued to use his full strength without showing any mercy. With the attack, the space around Jian Chen froze, trapping him once again. Saint Kings at great perfection had already reached the very peak of Saint King. They were only an inch away from becoming a Saint Emperor, and they were the closest existences to Saint Emperor. Ching Yang King Yun possessed an absolute advantage over Jian Chen, who was just a seventh heavenly layer Saint King. This time, Jian Chen could not break through the frozen space in time. All he could do was watch helplessly as Ching Yang King Yun's powerful attack rapidly drew closer. Chaotic force wildly surged within him, having pushed the chaotic body to the limit already. He planned on taking the attack head-on. At this moment, an old but straight figure suddenly appeared in front of Jian Chen. He was Ching Yang Zhu Zhao, and energy pulsed from him as tremendous amounts of world force coiled around him. Although his vast presence was not as great as Ching Yang King Yun's aura, he was not much weaker either. He then struck out with his palm, using invisible world force to fend off Ching Yang King Yun's attack. Boom! With a great rumble, terrifying energy ripples played out in a terrifying storm, which caused the entire piece of floating land to violently shake. The energy of the world convulsed. Ching Yang King Yun stood as still as a mountain, remaining where he was, but Ching Yang Zhu Zhao trembled gently. The ground where he stood had sunk a little. Ching Yang Zhu Zhao, what are you doing? Ching Yang King Yun sharply glared at Ching Yang Zhu Zhao. Ching Yang Zhu Zhao emotionlessly looked at Ching Yang King Yun. He said without any emotions whatsoever as well, "King Yun, are you going so far as to lay your hands so heavily on a junior?" "Xiangshan's a great elder of our clan. Moreover, great elder, HMPH, has there been any great elder who does not consider the clan's development first? He may be a great elder, but he's always been acting selfishly without considering for the clan at all. Is there any use for a great elder like that? From now on, I declare, in the name of the highest ranking elder, that Ching Yang Zhu Xiangshan will be removed of his position as Great Elder," Ching Yang King Yun coldly announced. "You need the agreement of the seven of us to remove a Great Elder from his position." "King Yun, you don't have the authority just by yourself," Ching Yang Zhu Zhao replied. "It doesn't matter if you remove me from the position or not. I'm no longer a member of the Protector Ching Yang clan, and from now on, I have no connection to it either," Jian Chen yelled as he struggled in the frozen space. By now, a large number of people had gathered in the distance. The fight in the garden had alerted the entire inner clan. Many people hurried over from all directions, hovering high in the sky as they watched from very far away. They had all been forbidden to get anywhere near the battle by a few great elders through communication techniques, so no one dared to head over. Killing intent filled Ching Yang King Yun's face. He made his way around Ching Yang Zhu Zhao and charged at Jian Chen. "King Yun, Xiangshan's a member of my Zhu branch. He cannot be trampled over like this by our King branch." Ching Yang Zhu Zhao blocked Ching Yang King Yun and clashed several dozen times with him at the speed of lightning. Ching Yang King Yun fell into utter rage after being blocked time and time again. He taunted, "Ching Yang Zhu Zhao, if you insist of shielding him from his mistakes, don't blame me for not showing you any respect. Show me just how much you've improved in the past few years." The two of them began to fight ferociously. As they fought, they moved from the land to the sky, and then from the sky to a cluster of mountains in the distance. Various creatures were alarmed as the powerful ripples of energy rocked the entire space. Many cracks constantly expanded and constantly healed together. Several mountains had collapsed under their battle. "I never thought that Zhu Zhao's strength had already reached the ninth heavenly layer and is about to reach great perfection. It won't be easy if King Yun wants to defeat Zhu Zhao," Ching Yang King Jury mumbled. The clansmen all stared at Ching Yang King Yun and Ching Yang Zhu Zhao as they fought in panic from afar. None of them knew what was happening. A lot of them felt uneasy when they saw the authoritative great elders fight in such an intense fashion. They all began to whisper in discussion, "Jury, Yun, come take down this wrongdoer for me," Ching Yang King Yun called out from afar. The confused clansmen all heard what Ching Yang King Yun had said, which immediately led to a great commotion. Various discussions rang out in all directions, But there were even more sounds of satisfaction made in the direction of Jian Chen. Jian Chen was young, where his actual age was not even a fraction of many of the people present, yet he had actually climbed his way up to a position of a great elder, looming above them all. This had led to the disagreement of many older people long ago, but it had all been suppressed by the great elders to the point that they could not mention it. Yet now, many people unhappy with Jian Chen no longer felt any fear because his wrongdoings had led to a fight between the two great elders. Various complaints constantly rang out. Cheng Yanqing Jui and Cheng Yanqing Yun were all people of the same branch. They did not hesitate at all when they heard what Cheng Yanqing Yun said and immediately charged toward Jian Chen. Cheng Yang Zhu Yangxiao sneered and went up to face them. He stopped Cheng Yanqing Yun. Yangxiao, looks like you want to fight with me. Your strength may have increased, having broken through to the fifth heavenly layer, but you're still not my opponent. It's best if you don't interfere with this matter, just in case we end up falling out, Cheng Yanqing Yun said. What a joke. You've decided to mistreat the people of my branch so roughly and in such a brazen fashion, yet you want to persuade me to not interfere? Cheng Yang Zuyun stood firm with his decision and was not swayed at all. I have nothing else to say if that's the case, Cheng Yanqing Yun coldly replied and began fighting with Cheng Yang Zuyangxiao. On another side, Cheng Yanqing Jui began to fight Jian Chen as well. However, he was only a Saint King of the fifth heavenly layer, so he was nowhere near Jian Chen's opponent. After just clashing a few times, he lost an arm to Jian Chen and wailed out uncontrollably from the pain. How dare you? The crime for injuring a great elder cannot be forgiven. Wu Ji, Zhanghua, you two quickly come and capture the traitor of the clan. Cheng Yanqing Yun noticed the situation over there and furiously called out as he fought Cheng Yang Zhu Zhao. He was boiling with rage. Cheng Yanyu on Wu Ji and Cheng Yanyu on Zhanghua hesitated slightly before heading toward Jian Chen in the end. Cheng Yanyu on Wu Ji was the stronger of the two, having reached the eighth heavenly layer of Saint King, while Cheng Yanqing Zhanghua was the weaker one, at the fourth heavenly layer. Jian Chen's pressure immediately increased when the two of them took part in the battle. He quickly fell to a disadvantage. It was rather difficult for Jian Chen to handle them, especially Cheng Yanyu on Wu Ji, who was at the eighth heavenly layer of Saint King. You have gone too far, Yuan and King branches, Cheng Yang Zhu Zhao roared out as he fought Cheng Yanqing Yun. A violent presence radiated from him as his hair and clothes fluttered despite the absence of wind. Invisible world force in the surroundings rapidly gathered around him. Cheng Yang Zhu Yangxiao looked at the sky, and he held his right hand as a fist over his head. His body was filled with a wildly domineering presence, as if he was about to challenge the world. A ball of faint white light suddenly appeared where his fist was, before turning white hot in the blink of an eye. It seemed like a miniature sun, illuminating the surroundings. Founding God's Fist. It's the Founding God's Fist. Cheng Yang Zhu Yangxiao, why you're actually going to use the Founding God's Fist to deal with me? Cheng Yanqing Yun paled in fright. He immediately shot back as he hurriedly circled his hands in the air. He created layers of defenses using a secret technique in front of him while Saint Force surged from his body at the same time. It condensed into a layer of armor on him. Cheng Yanqing Yun and the two great elders of the Yuan branch's expressions changed slightly as well. They felt great fear for the Founding God's Fist. It was an extremely powerful and violent punching technique created by a talented ancestor of the Zhu branch. It was an extremely powerful Saint Tier battle skill, having reached the limits of Saint Tier battle skills and touching the edge of another domain. It was just a pity that the battle skill had always been controlled by the Zhu branch, so the people from the other two branches could not comprehend it. Chapter 1174, The Founding God's Fist. Yangxiao, you're actually using the Founding God's Fist against your own clansmen. Do you know what you're going right now? Cheng Yanqing Yun furiously roared as he fought against Cheng Yang Zhu Zhao. However, what he said was not enough to stop Cheng Yang Zhu Yangxiao. The Founding God's Fist was a powerful battle skill that bordered a whole different domain, so even with Cheng Yang Zhu Yangxiao's strength, he needed some time to charge it up. The weather in the surrounding area suddenly began to change. As he charged up the battle skill, The rich energy and world force in the independent world began to move violently, creating storms of energy and kicking dust into the air. The entire floating land gently trembled. The space around Qingying Zhuyangxiao began to violently shake. It wildly twisted, obscuring him and making his figure appear bent from time to time. Extremely powerful energy had condensed where his fist was. Transcendence, supreme shielding. As Qingying Zhuyangxiao's opponent, Qingying Qingyun shouted out as well. He used an ancient secret technique, using spatial force to create a spatial obstruction between him and Qingying Zhuyangxiao, as if they had been separated by two different worlds. Suddenly, a tremendous pressure appeared. It was so powerful that all the saint rulers who were watching from afar shuddered unknowingly, and many people below saint ruler had even collapsed to the ground. Some of the weaker people had even vomited blood. Just the pressure had ruptured their organs and made them heavily injured. The pressure was exceptionally great, far more powerful than other saint-tier battle skills. Such a skill was extremely rare on the Tianyuan continent, and only saint kings could resist it. Qingying Zhuyangxiao bathed in a dazzling light. He seemed like a god, possessing an absolute will. His fist slightly moved toward Qingying Qingyun from afar. His fist did not move fast at all. In fact, it could be described as extremely slow. However, as he punched, he seemed to have invoked some mysteries and powerful energies of the world, causing the muffled rumble of thunder to ring through the space. With a single punch, the weather changed and everything fell silent. The punch seemed to have replaced the world, becoming the only existence that moved. It was the most eye-catching thing in the world. The punch seemed to have used all the power in the surroundings. It shot forward with an unstoppable force in the form of an angered dragon. The founding god's fist had already reached the peak of saint-tier battle skills and had already reached the border of a whole different domain. It was close to transcending the saint-tier. The fist collided with a spatial barrier from Qingying Qingyun first, yet it was unable to stop it at all. The fist easily made its way through, causing the space there to violently shake. A region of it had already shattered, disintegrating into darkness, but it recovered very quickly. The battle skill was not weakened after making it through the barrier. It continued to surge toward Qingying Qingyun with great might. Qingying Qingyun became extremely stern. He had already been locked onto by the battle skill, so it could not be dodged easily, especially since it had virtually surpassed the saint tier. He could only take it head-on, unable to flee. The punch came in contact with the layers of defenses cast down through secret techniques with an earth-shaking commotion. It broke through all obstructions and landed on Qingying Qingyun's body mercilessly. Spurt. Blood immediately sprayed from Qingying Qingyun's mouth as mist. He was completely blown away, passing through several mountains along the way before finally becoming lodged in another mountain. There were no signs of movement from him for quite a long time. Qingying Zhuyangxiao, I definitely won't let you off easily for being so heavy-handed against a great elder, Qingying Qingyun furiously yelled again. His presence quickly skyrocketed, and he began to use his full strength regardless of the consequences. He blew Qingying Zhuyao away with a single palm strike before flying toward Qingying Zhuyangxiao as a furious streak of light. The light around Qingying Zhuyangxiao was extraordinarily blinding. After the attack, the might of the battle skill had no dispersed yet. He only stared at Qingying Qingyun in interest with no fear at all. Afterward, he punched toward Qingying Qingyun in the exact same manner. With the punch, everything fell silent. It seemed to have become the only existence in the world, possessing an unbelievable amount of force. Qingying Qingyun showed no emotion in his icy cold eyes. Although Qingying Zhuyangxiao's battle skill had surpassed saint tier, it was still limited by his strength after all. It was not enough to threaten Qingying Qingyun. Soul obliterating palm strike. Qingying Qingyun sneered. He struck his hand against the founding god's fist, and a pressure descended from the surroundings. It was also a saint-tier battle skill, except it was nowhere as great as the founding god's fist, but with his strength at great perfection, Qingying Qingyun could use it instantaneously. The two saint-tier battle skills collided in the air and a great boom erupted. Terrifying ripples of energy dissipated into the surroundings, almost causing the space there to shatter. The 18 divine halls high up in the sky had become even more consolidated now, holding the whole space in place. The two battle skills were equally matched and dispersed at the same time. Although the two battle skills varied in base power, the disparity in their caster's cultivation level was just far too great, which was why this difference in power could be made up. Before Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao could recover from casting the battle skill, Qing Yang King Yun arrived in front of him with a flash. He hit Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao with a palm strike, which passed through the brilliance of the founding god's fist to land on his chest. Spurt! A cloud of blood shot from Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao's mouth and blood immediately drained from his face. He was blown far away by Qing Yang King Yun's attack, now heavily injured. I will never forgive you, Qing Yang King Yun. Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao was utterly enraged. He charged over from afar as his eyes boiled with killing intent. Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao was his great-grandson and, more importantly, the pride of the Zhu branch. Qing Yang Zhuzhao's anger had reached an irrevocable level after watching Qing Yang King Yun injure Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao. Qing Yang Zhuzhao's presence rapidly skyrocketed, reaching his peak very soon. It seemed like he was about to use the founding god's fist. Qing Yang King Yun glared at Qing Yang Zhuzhao and called out, "Qing Yang Zhuzhao, your Zhu branch has the founding god's fist, but my King branch has the nurture of spring. If we really do clash, the people who'll get hurt will only be the clansmen. Do you want to become labeled as an eternal traitor?" Qing Yang King Yun's eyes were filled with fear. He was able to dismiss Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao's founding god's fist, but he needed to face the same battle skill cast by Qing Yang Zhuzhao carefully. A gleam of light flickered through Qing Yang Zhuzhao's eyes. After a moment of deliberation, he gave up on the thought of using the battle skill. Jian Chen's battle against the two great elders of the Yuan branch was intense. He was littered with wounds and very heavily injured. Qing Yang Yuan Zhengwe was also covered in many slashes from a sword. He was also heavily injured. Chapter 1175, Descent of the Bright Moon Divine Hall. Of the two great elders from the Yuan branch, Qing Yang Yuan Zhengwe was weaker than Jian Chen, but Qing Yang Yuan Wuji was an 8th heavenly layer saint king. He was the third strongest person of the clan and his strength completely surpassed Jian Chen's. Every single strike of his possessed mountain-shattering force, and he would use ancient secret techniques from time to time. It was very difficult for Jian Chen cope with, so he fell to a disadvantage. All the heavy injuries on Jian Chen had basically come from Qing Yang Yuan Wuji, but the chaotic body gifted him with great vitality and battle prowess at the same time. His strength did not decrease at all despite his injuries, but he could not last for too long either. Bang! With a muffled sound, Qing Yang Yuan Wuji's palm landed on Jian Chen's chest, launching him far away. The attack was very powerful. Jian Chen only stopped after flying several thousand meters and after colliding into a mountain. His entire chest had caved in and most of his ribs were broken. Jian Chen clenched his teeth and chaotic force quickly circulated within him. He recovered just as quickly, but even with that, his speed of recovery was far slower than the rate he was sustaining injuries. Jian Chen glanced around and saw that Qing Yang Zhuzhao and Qing Yang King Yun were still fighting far away. Tremendous ripples of energy wreaked havoc in the surroundings, causing whole clusters of mountains to tremble. On the other hand, there were no signs of movement from Qing Yang Zhuyangxiao after he had been blown away by Qing Yang King Yun. Jian Chen's face was extremely ashen. He was completely at a disadvantage right now. He could rival 7th Heavenly Layer Saint Kings if he fought by himself, but he was helpless against Qing Yang Yuan Wuji no matter how hard he tried. As a great elder, Qing Yang Yuan Wuji knew many powerful ancient secret techniques, so no ordinary Saint King could compare to him. The independent space was sealed as well, and it could not be opened without the corresponding technique. He was now trapped here and unable to leave. Energy pulsed up ahead as Qing Yang Yuan Wuji aggressively flew over. He glared fixedly at Jian Chen, as if he was afraid that Jian Chen would run away. Greed was evidently plastered across his face. Now that King Yun's busy with Zhuzhou, it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for me. I'll eat the fruit as soon as I get it. And he can't do anything to me. All he can do is watch from the side. I'll be able to reach the supreme realm of Saint Emperors very soon and become the strongest of the protector clans. Cheng Yanyuan Wuji laughed maniacally inside. He could basically taste the moment he would become a Saint Emperor, but he needed to suppress his wild excitement, or he would have begun laughing aloud. But this brat's talent is very great. He'll probably reach Saint Emperor himself without much time, so he's a huge threat to me. He's going to suffer a death sentence today anyway, so I might as well go all in and finish him off right now. Thinking up to there, heavy killing intent immediately flashed through Cheng Yanyuan Wuji's eyes. He had made up his mind about killing Jian Chen since he had decided he would take the fruit. A silver lance completely condensed from energy appeared in Cheng Yanyuan Wuji's hand. With its materialization, a powerful pressure appeared in the surroundings, crushing Jian Chen like a mountain. It caused his body to sink and stopped all his actions. This was the pressure of a Saint-tier battle skill that originated from Cheng Yanyuan Wuji. The silver lance turned into a white streak of light, shooting toward Jian Chen with lightning-like speed. Jian Chen was stern. With a thought, the Saint artifact immediately transformed into a 10-meter-tall golden tower in front of him, helping him withstand Cheng Yanyuan Wuji's Saint-tier battle skill. At the same time, a 3-meter-tall figure appeared beside Jian Chen with a flash of golden light. He was an extremely burly man who seemed like a small giant. His skin was goldish-brown, and a golden brilliance radiated from him. This figure was Tai Ta, who had remained within the Saint artifact. Jian Chen had secretly informed Tai Ta long ago that the situation outside was very dangerous. As soon as he appeared, a dense layer of golden light surrounded him, and he called out, "Mysteries of War, World's Fist." The golden light around him condensed on his hand, and at that moment, a wondrous power actually revolved around his fist. He then smashed the space in front of him viciously. Thrum. Tai Ta's punch actually produced an extremely unique sound. It seemed like the creaking and painful wailing of space. It began to violently shake with Tai Ta's attack, showing signs of ripping apart. The 18 divine halls in the sky consolidated even more than before. Every single one of them radiated with an energy that fused with the independent space, reinforcing it so that it became even more powerful than the outside world. The space became indestructible, like a metal cage. The shaking space stabilized very quickly. Tai Ta's expression immediately changed when he saw this, and he said, "Jian Chen, I can't break through the space here." "What?" Jian Chen was shocked. He asked, "Tai Ta, didn't you say that your mysteries of war can break through all limitations of space and travel through the void and that you can go anywhere you want to?" Tai Ta scratched his head in a panic. He nervously replied, "That's what the information I received said. My world's fist can indeed break through the limitations of any region of space, but I never thought it would be so tough here. It's become useless. Looks like my strength is too weak and my level of understanding regarding the technique isn't enough." "God damn it," Jian Chen swore inside. The plan could not adapt to the changing situation. He had never imagined it would end up like this. It was already night outside right now. A full moon hung high in the sky, casting down beautiful moonlight. A silver-white divine hall silently descended from outer space before stopping above the entrance to the Qingyang clan's independent space. The beautiful Yu Yu, dressed in white, stood on top of the roof as she held the moon god scepter that Fairy Hao Yu had given her. Suddenly, Yu Yu raised the scepter and the gem embedded within it began to shine with dense moonlight. At the same time, the full moon in the sky suddenly grew brighter. It actually began to shine with unprecedented brightness, as if it was resonating with Yu Yu's scepter. The two of them seemed to be calling out to each other from far away. "I never thought that you'd have a helper, but inside the Protector Clan, it's useless even if you bring a Saint King at great perfection." Cheng Yanyuan Wuji sneered back inside the independent space. The energy around him surged and rushed toward Jian Chen. Tai Ta's eyes slid over. A golden axe appeared in his hand, and he yelled, "Mysteries of War, Destruction." A supreme battle intent suddenly appeared. It was enough to affect everyone's mind. At that moment, All the clansmen who were watching from afar lost any bravery to fight as their morale collapsed. All of them shivered under the battle intent as they looked at Taita in dread. At that moment, Taita seemed to have become an undefeatable war god in the eyes of many of them. Even saint rulers had lost their courage to fight in front of Taita. An extremely dazzling streak of light shot through the air, heading toward Qing Yanyu on Wuji like a bolt of lightning along with the battle intent. Qing Yanyu on Wuji blanked out. The sudden battle intent had affected him slightly as well, but he could suppress the effects with his strength, so he recovered very quickly. Seeing the golden axe flying over, he wanted to dodge, but discovered that it had already locked on to his presence. He hurried and used an ancient secret technique and managed to block Taita's attack, but the powerful force launched him far away. What is this presence? Qing Yang Qingyan and Qing Yang Zuzhao stopped fighting in the distance. They glanced at Taita's doubt and surprise flooded their faces. The mysteries of war, destruction, isn't this a powerful battle skill used by the war god of the hundred races, Urgens, in ancient times, the one mentioned in the records? The records say that Urgens had used it to destroy a small portion of the entire continent with a single swing, and over 10 saint emperors died to it. Qing Yang Qingyan stared blankly as disbelief flooded his face. Qing Yang Zuzhao stared at Taita's Taita bathed in golden light from afar. He murmured, surrounded in golden light and able to give off such a unique battle intent. I is he. That's the war god of the hundred races. No wonder the hundred races had launched a large-scale invasion of our continent. That had never happened before after all, so it turns out to be all connected to the war god. Qing Yang Qingyan suddenly called out. He immediately guessed Taita's identity and became both fearful and surprised. Even with his mental fortitude, he struggled to remain calm. The war god of the hundred races was just far too famous. His prestige was so great that even saint emperors would pale upon hearing about him. After all, he was a sovereign-like figure that had surpassed saint emperor. In ancient times, just the amount of saint emperors that fell by his hand was innumerable. Only other experts at the same level of cultivation could match up against him. However, Qing Yang Qingyan realized Taita's strength very soon. He immediately calmed down very much and killing intent began to flow from his eyes in an undisguised manner. He said, "Zuzhao, the war god of the hundred races has reappeared. We may not have been part of the matters during the ancient times, but you understand very well from the records. You know what you should be doing at this moment." Qing Yang Zuzhao frowned heavily. He stared at Taita fixedly as the light within his eyes flickered. Before the war god has fully matured, kill him immediately and remove the future danger. Otherwise, the Tianyu on continent will become doomed. The tragedy of the ancient times will be repeated. But this time, we don't have an expert like Mo Tanyan to stop him. "Zuzhao, let's forget our disagreements for now and kill the war god together," Qing Yang Qingyan coldly said. He charged toward Taita first after he finished speaking. Rumble. At this moment, a deafening boom rang out from the sky, causing the entire clan to violently shake.